Tan. Good morning, sir. The chair wishes to make a preliminary statement. If you have watched the award-winning TV series House of Cards, you must have come across Frank Underwood's statement on his rule on ruthlessness. And I quote, "The road to power is paved with hypocrisy and casualties." Subliminally, one can easily draw parallelism in that quote I just mentioned with the turn of events in the killing of Albuera late Mayor Rolando Espinosa and fellow detainee Raul Yap, which your Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs concluded and which the Senate unanimously affirmed as premeditated and with grave abuse of authority on the part of CIDG Region 8 operatives. Perhaps more ruthless than the killing of Espinosa and fellow inmate Raul Yap are, one, the DOJ resolution dated May 29, 2017, signed by Undersecretary Reynante Orseo, dismissing the complaint for murder and downgrading it to homicide. Two, EIA's resolution slapping a four-month suspension against Superintendent Marcos, one rank demotion and six-month suspension for the others, and three, granting back-to-duty status to Marcos as Regional Director of CIDG Region 12. Expectedly, this triple whammy of ruthless acts elicited public outrage and disgust among legislators from both houses of Congress. Quite honestly, when Committee Report Number 46 was adopted unanimously in plenary, I thought, we have already put to rest the Espinosa case. But due to recent turn of events, we now find ourselves here at the session hall once again. There's no saying that we do not respect our courts and their mandate to ensure the administration of justice. However, we cannot turn a blind eye to apparent irregularities duly reported. My bigger concern, and this is personal, having come from the same police force that I value and love so dearly, is the far-reaching implication of this whole scenario to the morale and discipline among the police ranks that could impact on their efficiency and performance to the detriment of the overall peace and order situation in our country. With that, the chair welcomes all the resource persons to the public inquiry in the exercise of the oversight functions of the Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs in relation to Committee Report Number 46. In addition, today's agenda shall also include Senate Resolution Number 413, authored by Senator Bam Aquino, entitled Resolution Directing the Appropriate Senate Committee to Conduct an Investigation in Aid of Legislation on the contradictory issuance of the Department of Justice with regard to the killing of late Mayor Espinosa in his jail cell, unquote, and Senate Resolution Number 438, filed by this representation, dealing with the same subject matter. Let us proceed. For the record, I would like to acknowledge the presence of Police Director General Ronald De La Rosa, Chief of the Philippine National Police, Police Director Rene Aspera, Director DPRM, Attorney Alpegar Triambulo, the Director General of IAS, no? Vice Chairman Rogelio Casurao. Ito ba si Vice Chairman? Undersecretary Reynante Orseo. Acting Prosecutor General George Catalan, Jr. Good morning, sir. I'd like to acknowledge the presence of the author of the resolution, Senator Bam Aquino. Good morning, sir. The panel of prosecutors, as per Department Order 890, dated December 7, 2016, namely Senior Deputy State Prosecutor Pedrito Rances, Senior Assistant State Prosecutor Lilian Doris Alejo, Senior Assistant State Prosecutor Olivia Torrevillas, Assistant State Prosecutor Jinky De Dumo, Assistant State Prosecutor Carla Cabel, Attorney Moises Acayan, Director Dante Gyaran, Director of the National Bureau of Investigation, Attorney Delemos, Luigi, good morning. Then Attorney, oh, nasan si Leo? Si Bong Luterio, wala. Ah, NBI. Ah, Luterio. Who else? Mr. Henry Abiera? NBI. Ah, kayo nang imbisiga? Okay. So, the same procedure, we will recognize the senators who wish to ask their questions according to their order of arrival. So, since Senator Hunasan came here first, unless you want to defer to Senator Bam, being the author. Go ahead. Wait a minute. Comsec, paki ano lang, administer yung oath to the resource persons.
May I request our resource persons to please stand? Please raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in the Senate inquiry? Thank you. Please be seated.
Senator Nathan.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, I will direct my first round of questions to General De La Rosa. And siguro, Ronald, you can point to anybody if the question involves a legal response. Okay, but I'll ask my questions para you will know what where I'm coming from. Ang objective talaga natin dito, beyond the personalities involved, is to institutionalize the reforms that not only the present dispensation has initiated, but previous dispensations. No? The president, with his management and style of governance, is treading on a new ground. Now, ang unang tanong ko, Director General Del Rosa, is how much discretion legally? You have to understand, no, I come from a different branch of service. No, in a previous lifetime, Senator Lacson, the chairman, has that advantage. No, I'm not intimately familiar with the legalities, the technical aspects, no, of what applies to an organization, a bureau under the Department of Interior and Local Government, no? That is civilian in character and national in scope. Okay. Having said that, ano ang discretion dito ng ating Pangulo beyond what is prescribed in your rules and regulations when you deal with cases like this? Of course, ultimately, has the... I'm explaining, no? You sort this out na lang. He said that he supports the officer involved. But I'm not worried about this particular officer. I'm worried about the others who are similarly involved. At the end of the day, he says if he is convicted, he will be pardoned. These are bold statements. So my first question is, does this all, from where you sit, fall under the discretionary powers of the Commander-in-Chief, the President? Just point me to any resource person present in the conference room or behind you, anybody present in the hall, para I can get a response. Okay lang, sir. Yes. Okay, while you are looking around for the one who will give me the answer.
Sir,
before you continue. Alam mo ang worry ko kasi dito, Ronaldo, ladies and gentlemen. We have a new president. He has his own style, no? Ang worry ko dito is after him, if the next president or whatever we will call him, if we move federal, no, is not that bold, then we will shift again, we will whiplash from one end of the pendulum to another. So, lumalapad yung discretionary dimension ito. Ang gusto ko lang gawin is i-narrow down ito para we will not inflict on our future leaders this discretionary burden. Yung kaya nating i-cover sa batas, no, sa regulasyon ninyo, makover na para unnecessary na yung ipapardon, hindi ipapardon, reversal of the initial findings. That is what generates a reaction from your legislators. We just want to be consistent para kahit na sino ang presidente, kung sino yung bossing natin, meron tayong parameters. I hope you understand what I'm saying, Ronald.
Sir, we are being governed by RA 6975.
Okay.
And aside from that, we are also being governed by NAPOLCOM memorandum circulars and PNP memorandum circulars for the administrative aspect of all our activities, Your Honor. And I could hardly answer your question as far as the discretion of the president in giving pardon to whoever from the PNP getting convicted of any offense, Your Honor, because I'm not a lawyer.
Okay.
But per advice of my seatmate here, the the pardon is a discretionary power of the president, Your Honor.
Wag na muna yung pardon. Yusek Orseo, can you...
Yes.
By the way, I understand completely, Director General De La Rosa. No? I just want to narrow down, zero in, on what... Yung pardon, wag na muna. Dinagdag ko lang yon para kompleto. Before the pardon, what under what discretionary powers, Yusek Orseo, you're volunteering, no, to respond.
Does
the president have?
Based on the Constitution, the president has an absolute authority to grant pardon to any convicted felons, Your Honor.
Okay. By the way, I'll repeat what I said. No, forget about the pardon. My mistake. Yung bago dumating dun sa sinabi ng ating Pangulo na pag nakumbike yan, ipapardon ka. Well, this is good, no? That's why the morale of the PNP and the AP are very high because of this unique management style of the president. I hope you're getting what I'm saying, Yusek Orseo. So, bago yung pardon, huwag mo muna isama yung pardon. Dun sa before the pardon, findings ng IAS, findings ng NBI.
I think, Your Honor, the president has no authority in so far as before the pardoning of the fellows is concerned, because before the authority of the president to grant pardon, there should be a judicial proceedings. And in so far as other judicial proceedings are concerned, the president has no authority to even intervene in the co-equal branch of the government.
Okay, I understand, Yusek Orseo. Now, let me go back to Director General De La Rosa, and he can go back to you if you are competent to respond. No? Ano ang sinasabi dun sa Republic Act at saka dun sa NAPOLCOM circular about dealing with cases like this? If you notice, I do not mention personalities, okay? Because this is an issue that governs the performance of duty of the bureau called the Philippine National Police and its personnel. Anong sinasabi sa atin nung Republic Act at saka nung NAPOLCOM circulars?
Your Honor, can I request my Inspector General of IAS to answer the question?
Yes, please.
Your Honor.
Attorney Triambulo. Yes, please.
Good morning, sir.
By the way, I'm not blaming anybody.
Yes,
I'm
sir.
Just putting this across para maintindihan ko at maintindihan ng inyong committee at yung mga mambabatas natin.
Sir, we have a system of disciplinary mechanism sa PNP po yon, provided by RA 6975, which is the Local Government Act of 1990, and the as amended by the 8551, yung PNP Reorganization Act. Ito po ay in-implement po yung disciplinary mechanism ng NAPOLCOM circular, no? So dito po binigyan po si Chief PNP ng power to discipline over the PNP members, while the IAS is the one conducting the investigation, prosecution, and summary hearing. Now, hindi po, wala po yung papasok yung discretion ng presidente. Pag yung may decision na po yung Chief PNP, under the rules, siya po ay yung respondent, agree by the decision of the Chief PNP, pupunta po yan sa NAPOLCOM.
Okay.
Para mag-apila. Pag natalo sa NAPOLCOM, pipili siyang pupunta ng Civil Service Commission. Because ang decision ng NAPOLCOM, party na po yung secretary ng DILG doon, okay, as chairman. And then, papunta na po yun sa korte, sir. Now, papasok lang po yung executive clemency ng presidente to pardon doon sa kanyang administrative office kung ayaw mag-apila ang respondent at hihingi ng clemency. But there is a prescribed period provided by NAPOLCOM. Kailangan 5 years muna po siyang natanggal sa serbisyo bago siya makahingi ng executive clemency.
Okay. Attorney Triambulo, no? So, sequence, timeline natin. IAS muna. After IAS, Chief PNP. What does the Chief PNP do? Review.
Render a decision because IAS is merely recommendatory.
Okay. So, recommend the Chief PNP. Tapos, whatever the Chief PNP decides, based on the merits of the case, pag-i-appeal NAPOLCOM. Saan pumasok yung NBI?
Wala po, sir, because that is a criminal aspect of the case.
So, wala ditong intervention yung NBI?
Wala po.
Okay. Dahil dito sa IAS report, correct me if I'm wrong, yung mga nasa loob, conspiracy. Nung kulungan?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yung iba na nasa labas, ano ang ano sa kanila?
More on na si Marcos lang po yung may penalty sa labas po, sir. Siya po ay command responsibility because being the head of the operating team. Because under the rules, sinabi kasi ng Revised Penal Code, Article 8, na para magkakaroon ng conspiracy, kailangan yung two or more person enter into agreement to commit a crime and decided to commit. No. And it can be proved by a direct evidence or circumstantial evidence. So wala pong direct evidence linking na mayroong agreement prior to the implementation of warrant and resulted to the death of the Mayor Espinosa and Yap. So, but yung circumstances inside the jail, yung synchronized action ng mga operatives doon, doon yung pinabasihan namin na mayroong conspiracy exists. And then, so therefore, yung si Marcos na sa labas, na wala namang mere presence under the Supreme Court ruling kasi mere presence of the scenes of the crime, na wala namang proof of agreement and cooperation, so hindi kasama po sa conspiracy.
Okay. So, ulitin ko, Attorney Triambulo, no? So, IAS, and then Chief PNP. Saan pumasok Director General De La Rosa? Yung judgment call ko. Mo, in the determination of who is part of the conspiracy or who is not. Doon ka na nag-intervene.
Your Honor, my decision is dependent on the recommendation of the IAS. So, the resolution that is given to me by IAS, it is either I will approve or disapprove it. So, since I saw that the investigation was done properly, so I approve the recommendation of IAS. That is 4 months suspension for Superintendent Marcos and one rank demotion for others.
Okay, before you continue. 4 months suspension for Superintendent Marcos?
Yes, Your Honor.
For what?
For command responsibility, Your Honor.
Okay. Wala siya sa loob ng kulungan, yung incident?
Yes, Your Honor. Nasa labas siya.
Yung iba,
nasa loob.
Hagip sa conspiracy?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, nag-appeal ba si Superintendent Marcos?
Yes, Your Honor.
Sa NAPOLCOM?
Motion for recommendation.
Okay.
Motion for reconsideration.
Okay. Okay.
So that is why the decision that I have signed, Your Honor, was not yet implemented. It's not yet implemented because of this motion for reconsideration.
Last question. Itong pronouncements ni Presidente, did it happen before, during, or after this process, this procedure?
I cannot determine exactly, Your Honor, but the pronouncement of the President was continuous. Every now and then he
in other words, he before, speaks, during, and after.
Most likely, Your Honor, because tuloy-tuloy yun. Every may appearance siya sa media, he always say that, Your Honor.
Naintindihan natin yan, di ba? We're getting to know our President better now. Ngayon, ang tanong ko, kaya ako tinanong yun, yung before, during, and after, itong prosesong ito, di ba? Kaya tinatanong ko nung simula pa, yung discretionary powers, which includes making pronouncements over media, hindi natin yan, that's the President to reinvent himself, no? I'm being brutally frank. Hindi naman naapektuhan itong prosesong ito dahil sa mga pinagsasabi ng ating Pangulo.
Your Honor, kung basihan natin yung pinagsasabi ni Presidente, Your Honor, it has not affected our decision, Your Honor. Because for the record, Your Honor, he did not call me up to give instructions on whether to absolve or to penalize Marcos. Hindi po siya nakialam, Your Honor. Yung kanyang mga kilala naman natin si Presidente, Your Honor, yung mga sinasabi niya sa TV, pinapakinggan natin, but the investigation was independent, Your Honor. The decision that I have come up was independent of his pronouncement on the TV, Your Honor.
Okay, I will take your word for it, no? General Del Rosa, because you know naman, from my view, the Philippine presidency, and I have said this time and again, not the president, the presidency, no, is one of the most powerful presidencies, if not the most powerful, among the remaining presidential democracies. So, whether you have said this in public or not, no, that comes with the power of the Philippine presidency. Lahat man tayo na kikinig sa radyo, nanonood ng TV, di ba? Ayaw lang natin, in our effort to institutionalize these reforms, no, na maapektuhan yung proseso. Dahil nakikinig tayo, siguro yung nag-iimbestiga, sabi ni Presidente, ganito raw. Kampi siya sa ganito o sa ganito, baka maapektuhan yung proseso. Okay? That's just my point. Mr. Chairman, I'll stop muna at this point, then reserve for later. Thank you. Thank you.
Senator Bam. Maraming salamat, Mr. Chairman. Magandang umaga sa mga panauhin po natin. General De La Rosa, good morning. Yusek Orseo, good morning. Nasaan po si Secretary Aguirre?
Your Honor, he has a prior commitment. And I believe he has submitted a letter here that he cannot come before this Senate.
For the record, Senator Bam, he informed me that he cannot make it in today's hearing because he has a prior commitment somewhere in Central Luzon, di ba?
Yeah.
All right. And Your Honor.
Okay, sayang naman. Hindi kami nakita ngayon. Yusek Orseo, I'm sure you'll be able to answer all the questions well. And kayo rin po yung pumirma, no? At the end of the what's the technical term for this? Yung pag magsusulat kayo sa korte na i-downgrade? Petition, no?
Yes, kayo, there's a petition for review and we call the paper that I signed as a resolution, Your Honor.
Okay, so you signed the resolution looking at the downgrade of the charges from murder to homicide. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So pupunta tayo doon, no? Para po kasi sa akin, dalawa yung issue. One is the downgrading. Kung paano po nangyari yung downgrading. And later on, I'm sure si Yusek Orseo will be able to answer all of those questions. And mamaya, yung reinstatement, no? And I'll ask PNP Chief kung ano po talaga yung nangyari dito at ano ba yung status nito, no? Okay. Sa kaliwa po namin is the NAPROS, and they are the original DOJ panel na nagsagawa ng original recommendation from the DOJ. Is that correct? Who will be speaking for NAPROS? Prosecutor Alejo, kayo po?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, kayo po yung gumawa ng original na report mula sa DOJ na nabaliktad or naiba after the resolution provided by USEC or SEO. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Alright. Sa aking kanan naman, yung NBI, of course, Director Giran is here. Director, magandang umaga. Kayo rin po, no?
Good morning, sir.
Naglabas rin po kayo ng report tungkol dun sa pangyayaring pagpatay kay Mayor Espinosa. Tama po?
Yes, sir. It's a regular police investigation.
That's right. And during the hearings, nakapag-usap po tayo kung ano po yung initial findings ninyo. At this point, meron na po kayong, siguro, masasabi ho natin, mas advanced na yung inyong investigation pagdating po sa kasong ito. Because the last time tayo ho nag-usap, it was during this time also, and I think you had said these are just your initial findings, no? So by today, you will be able to tell us ano na talaga yung findings talaga ng NBI dun sa kaso pong ito. Is that correct?
I am not sure whether we have already concluded our investigation.
And before, you will be able to share with us the results of your investigation.
Yes, Your Honor. Right,
thank you. And of course, quite important to the Senate is the Senate Committee Report of Senator Lacson, no, na nandito po. I'll be quoting some passages from here later. This was signed by the members of the committees, if I'm not mistaken, and adopted. Wala naman pong tumutol, no? No objection. All right. So, simulan ho natin sa NAPROS, no? Prosecutor Alejo, in summary, although I do have your original DOJ panel report here. Anong date ho ito? This is?
It's dated March 2 po.
This is March 2.
Apo, 2017.
Just very quickly, ano po yung naging recommendations po ninyo dito sa inyong panel? And I see that almost all of you are here, no? The ones who signed are Alejo, Torrevillas, De Dumo, Cabel?
Yes, sir.
Cabel, Acayan?
Yes, sir.
Is Rances also here? Yes. Okay, so all of you are here. Kayo pong lahat, yes, na pumirma po dito, nandito po kayong lahat, no?
Yes, sir.
Itong report ninyo, binabago nyo po ba ang report ninyo, or do you stand by this report dated March
2017? We stand by our report, sir.
Okay, ano po yung nakalagay sa inyong report?
May I be allowed to read the dispositive portion, sir? Yes, sir. So, the dispositive portion of our report says that it is respectfully recommended the resolution that we drafted, and that the following criminal informations be filed pursuant to Section 2 of the Joint Circular of the Office of the Ombudsman and the Department of Justice and Republic Act Number 7975, which is an act to strengthen the functional and structural organization of the Sandigan Bayan, amending for the purpose Presidential Decree Number 1606 as amended. First, we recommended for the filing of one count of murder against respondents, Police Superintendent Santi Noel Matira, Police Chief Inspector Leo Laraga, SPO 4 Melvin M. Cayobit, and PO 3 Johnny A. Ibanez, Police Superintendent Marvin Win Marcos, Police Senior Investigator Diogracias P. Diaz III, SPO 2 Benjamin L. Dacalios, PO 3 Norman Abellanosa, PO 1 Gerland S. Cabillaan, Police Chief Inspector Calixto Canillas Jr., Police Senior Inspector Lucrecito Candilosas, SPO 2 Antonio R. Doxil, SPO 1 Mark Christian Cadillo, POT John Ruel Doculan, and PO 2 Jaime P. Baksal, all in relation to the death of the victim Mayor Rolando R. Espinosa. And then the second recommendation is for the filing of an information for one count of murder against respondents SPO 4 Juanito A. Duarte, PO 1 Lloyd O. Ortiguesa, Police Senior Inspector Fritz Blanco, and PO 1 Bernard Orpilla, and then Police Superintendent Marvin Win Marcos, Police Senior Inspector Diogracias Diaz III, SPO 2 Benjamin Dacalios, PO 3 Norman Abellanosa, PO 1 Gerland Cabillaan, Police Chief Inspector Calixto Canillas Jr., Police Senior Inspector Lucrecito Candilosas, SPO 2 Antonio R. Docil, SPO 1 Mark Christian Cadillo, PO 2 John Ruel Doculan, and PO 2 Jaime Baksal, this time in relation to the death of victim Mr. Raul Yap. And then the third recommendation is for the filing of two counts of violation of Article 129 of the Revised Penal Code, which is search warrants maliciously obtained and abuse in the service of those legally obtained against respondents Police Chief Inspector Leo Laraga, PO3 Norman Abellanosa, and Paul Olendan, which is in relation to search warrants numbers 2016-11. 11-20, that's against Mayor Espinosa for violation of RA 10591 and 2016-11-19 against Mr. Yap for violation of Republic Act number 9165. The fourth recommendation, sir, is for the filing of an information for one count of violation of Article 183, which is perjury of the Revised Penal Code against Respondent Repol Olendan. And then we also recommended a dismissal of the complaints against respondents Police Senior Inspector Eric P. Constantino, who was then in Lalo, Cagayan, SPO 2 Alfinor Serrano Jr., who reported to the office November 5, already 10 o'clock in the morning, PO 1 Crystal Jane Gisma, PO 1 Divine Grace Ongalia, who were all at home when the incident happened or occurred, and then PO2 Niel Centino, because he is AWOL. He was on AWOL, yes, sir. Former, they are dismissed. And we also recommended the dismissal of the complaint for the planting of evidence because the evidence was insufficient. There was evidence, but it was insufficient, sir, for a finding of probable cause. And then we also recommended, Your Honor, Your Honors, the filing of appropriate administrative complaints against Judge Tarcelo Sabarid, Executive Judge of Basay Sama Regional Court, Branch 30, for issuing the search warrant, Your Honor. The search warrants. It's all, Your Honor.
Okay. Thank you, Prosecutor Alejo. So, ito pong report po ninyo, this is upon the investigation of this panel, and it took you how many months to determine this report?
Your Honor, we were assigned this case in December and then we finished this in March, Your Honor.
Pangkaraniwang tatlong buwan, basically, no?
Yes,
pangkaraniwang oras po ba yon? Is that short? Is that long? Is that the usual amount of time that you come up with a report?
It was just interrupted by the holidays, Your Honor, the Christmas holidays.
So pangkaraniwan po ito,
yes,
sa
Your
inyo.
Honor. Yes,
meron po bang nanghimasok dito po sa paggawa ng inyong report from the DOJ, from the PNP, from the Senate? From anybody? Did anybody try to influence you dito po sa inyong report?
None, Your Honor.
None. And you're under oath, no?
Yes, Your Honor.
So wala hong tumawag na higher ups o kung sino man trying to tell you dapat ganito, dapat ganyan yung report? Wala po?
Wala po.
Okay. And when the DOJ or another part of the DOJ submitted the resolution recommending na ibaba po yung charge mula murder to homicide, ano po yung... Sinabihan mo kayo ahead of time that your report, in effect, would be overturned or ibabaliwala po yung report ninyo?
No, sir. Actually, sir, because when we filed the informations in Leyte, there was another panel constituted, prosecutors in Leyte, because it would be very expensive for us, for the whole panel to travel to Leyte and prosecute the case. So there was another panel constituted already as early as March 13, 2017, Your Honor.
Oh.
So in effect, when the new panel was created and designated to handle the case, we already have no authority over the case.
Okay, so pinasa nyo na sa kanila, in short.
Yes, Your Honor.
And were these prosecutors told that the another part of the DOJ would be overturning your report? O hindi nyo na alam?
We were not informed, Your Honor.
All right. But in short, kayo pong gumawa ng report na ito, it originated from you.
Yes, Your Honor.
It was submitted to the secretary, is that correct?
No, Your Honor, it was just signed by the prosecutor general, but he was on leave at that time, so it was signed by the OIC, officer in charge.
I just want to be clear, no?
Prosecutor Rances.
A report like this, kanino po ito pupunta? Pupunta po ba ito sa korte o sa DOJ rin?
Prosecutor General po muna, and then pag probable cause po, filing na information, sa korte na po.
Alright. So, hindi to usually dumadaan sa ibang mga sangay ng DOJ. That's the usual process po.
Apo.
Alright. So kailan niyo ho nalaman na nagkaroon ng pagbabago doon sa inyong recommendation? O sa TV niyo na lang po nalaman?
Actually po sa media na lang po.
Sa media na lang. And what was your reaction, Prosecutor Alejo?
Well, as usual po, katulad po ng mga ibang cases din ng DOJ, I feel it's just the prerogative of the SOJ.
So it's his prerogative. Yes. Nangyayari po ba yan usually? How many years have you been in the NAPROS po, in the prosecutor's office?
23 years.
23 years. Okay. This has happened many times or is this very unusual?
This has happened many times naman.
All right. So nangyayari naman po ito,
Apo.
To be fair.
Apo.
Okay, na yung report ng isang panel na babaliktad ng Secretary of Justice.
Yes po.
All right. So you found out in the media, but you're still here standing by your report.
Hindi, yes, sir.
Nabasa niyo naman po yung report na ginawa ni Yusek Orseo.
Yes, sir.
And you do not agree with him.
Sir, he has his own appreciation of the facts of the case and we have our own appreciation of the facts of the case.
Hindi naman ho nagbago ang isip niyo from his report. Baka naman mas maganda po yung report niya.
Hindi po, sir.
Hindi.
Maybe I'll have to rephrase sure, yes. With your permission. No? Ang tanong is ganito. Given the same, if you were to investigate this case again,
yes, sir.
Setting aside the resolution issued by Yusek Orseo, no?
Yes, sir.
Wala mo na yon. If you were to investigate this case again, given the same set of evidence, physical evidence, documentary evidence, given the same set of witnesses,
yes, sir.
Will you come up with the same finding of probable cause for murder?
Yes, sir.
Will you file the same criminal information for murder?
Yes, sir.
Okay. NBI, kasi kayo nag-conduct ng law enforcement investigation, given the same set of evidence, given the same set of witnesses, yung mismo investigator, siguro si Jerry Viera, will you still come up with the same criminal complaint for murder?
Yes, sir.
Ngayon, pagdating kay Yusek Orseo, meron bang nadagdag na ebidensya? I'm addressing this to Yusek Orseo.
Actually, only
if
one.
Any.
There's no additional evidence except that.
Walang additional evidence. Except pareho rin ang ebidensya ng NBI. Pareho rin ang ebidensya ng panel of prosecutors. Pareho rin ang ebidensya. Of course, mas maraming ebidensya nakuha yung NBI, I understand. Because I remember commending you in one of our hearings, di ba? The panel of prosecutors as well as the NBI investigators, we commended you for coming up with such a bold decision or finding of filing a criminal complaint for murder sa prosecutors. And this, in the same manner, ganun din ang gawa ng prosecutors. Ano? In spite of all the pronouncements of the president, public pronouncements, you still stood up to your what you believe should be the case filed, di ba? So, at wala naman nagdagdag na ebidensya pag-file ng petition for review. Bakit na iba yung findings ninyo?
Actually, Your Honor, it's about appreciation of evidence and facts, Your Honor. There's no additional
so
evidence.
So, the same set of evidence, the same facts, the same set of witnesses, iba yung appreciation mo.
Yes, Your Honor.
Sa appreciation ng Senate, sa appreciation ng NBI, sa appreciation ng panel of prosecutors.
That's good, Your Honor.
Okay. Thanks. Thank you, Senator.
All right. Before we go to you, Sec. Orseo, gusto ko lang pong linawin sa NBI, no, Director Giran. What were your final findings on this investigation? Close na po ito, di ba? Close na po siya.
You're right.
What were your findings po?
We have already communicated or transmitted our findings to the prosecutor's office.
All right.
And it was for murder, for the death of the two.
Yap and Espinosa.
And we have other recommendations for robbery and planting of evidence and against specific persons or people. We have just charged in our recommendation.
All right. Thank you, Director. So wala kayong binago. Even after this resolution from the DOJ, you're not convinced na dapat po ibaba to homicide ang charges kay Marcos at dun sa iba?
After we received the findings of Yusik Orsio about the downgrading of the case that we have earlier filed with the prosecutor's office or the in his DOJ panel. We have transmitted or we have written also our motion for reconsideration based on the findings of Secretary Orsio.
So nagsulat ho kayo ng motion for reconsideration sa DOJ?
That case, Your Honor, is rather the flow, Your Honor, is basically perfunctory under our laws. Meaning, after we lost on that case, we have also to file a reconsideration based on what we have earlier have found.
Sorry, a reconsideration with the court or a reconsideration with the DOJ with regard to their report?
On the petition for review, the result of the petition.
So that's with the DOJ, no?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. So, ibig ko sabihin yan, nakikita nyo ahead of time na babaguhin ng DOJ yung recommendation?
Hindi ho. Excuse me, Your Honor. It's not ahead of time.
So after then
after
po?
After the findings.
So, pagkatapos naglabas si Yusek Orseo ng kanyang resolution calling for the downgrade, nag-submit rin ho kayo ng motion for reconsideration sa kanila?
Opo. Simple lang. Ang ibig sabihin niyan, na gusto na naming linawin na hindi kami pabor doon sa...
Hindi kayo sumasang-ayon.
Kaya, nag-submit kami ng aming reconsideration na sana baguhin.
So, okay. Salamat po, Director. Let me just quote the conclusion, no? Page 25 of our committee report. Of course, Senator Lacson knows this by heart. Nakalagay po dito, based on thorough consideration of established procedures, jurisprudence, ordinary human experience, as well as testimonies offered and documents submitted during the joint public hearings conducted by the Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs and the Committee on Justice and Human Rights, the joint committee has reached the conclusion that the killing of Mayor Espinosa was premeditated and with abuse of authority on the part of the operatives of CIDG-8. Let me quote another line. Nakalagay po dito, the committees are convinced that the circumstances point out to a systematic cleanup made on any living trace that may reveal their involvement in the Espinosa drug trade. No? And of course, it's a much longer and more comprehensive report, pero I just like to quote those two lines. Mukhang nagkakasundo po ang original DOJ panel, ang NBI, at ang mga komite ng Senado na meron ngang murder na nangyari. Na meron pong nangyaring masamang bagay, masamang pangyayari that point not just to homicide but to murder. Now, lahat ng impormasyon pong ito nasa inyo po, Yusek Orseo, if I'm not mistaken. Tama po?
Not all, Your Honor. We don't have a copy on record of the Senate report, Your Honor.
All right. So hindi mo pa nakuha yung Senate report at that time?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. But nakuha mo yung DOJ panel?
Yes, Your Honor, because that's part of the records of the case, Your Honor.
At nakapaloob doon ang investigative findings ng NBI. Tama
yes,
po?
Yes, that's correct, Your Honor.
All right. So, Yusek Orseo, can you walk us through? Nakuha mo na yung original DOJ panel report. Alam mo yung nasabi ng NBI. I don't think the medical legal is here, but I remember in the first hearing, nabanggit po ng medical legal na tila imposible na nagharapan sila nung nagkaroon ng barilan. Yung isa ho ata, yung victim or yung si Espinosa, parang nakahiga, no? Parang ganun po yung nasabi ng medical legal. So, they also had some analysis, no? Tungkol dun sa firefighting na nangyari, and maybe NBI also had that same analysis, no? Na kasama po sa report nila. Lahat po yan nasa inyo. How come, baliktad po yung conclusion po ninyo? Kasi conclusion po ng ibang mga tao, murder ito, premeditated, and in fact, the committee even said this is part of a systematic cleanup of the drug trade. Bakit po yung lumabas sa inyong report, binaba at ginawang homicide? Ano po yung nagbago dun sa mga nakita po ninyo, kaya naging bago po ang inyong report?
Honor, let me start with the yardstick when you're going to qualify a crime, the offense into a murder. It is not simply premeditated. The rule said evident premeditated. That's two different things, Your Honor. That's too technical. The evident, the lapse of time, the sufficient lapse of time should be there before the offense can be qualified for a murder. And that's what I found out, that's lacking in the panel prosecution's report. One thing, the panel did not even include the positive result of the forensic examination, which was already in the NBI record. There was a report in the NBI that a gunpowder was positive on the hands of both the deceased, Espinosa and Yapa, Your Honor.
So, yun yung naging basehan mo sa pag-downgrade?
Among others, Your Honor.
Okay, but the main was hindi main evident was yung premeditation.
The premeditation is not evident because under the jurisprudence, there must be a sufficient lapse of time from the time the act was planned and as to its execution.
Alam mo, naka 1.5 years lang ako ng law school, pero di ba may ruling na yan na pag hindi naman siya ginawa in spur of the moment, di ba? Kapag, alam ko yun, maybe one of the lawyers here can help us. Wasn't there a case na even if it happens in a short span of time, it can still be premeditated kasi meron kang time to pause? If I'm not mistaken, help me out, Prosecutor Alejo, hindi ho ba may parang lesson yun noon na kapag meron kang panahon na pwede kang tumigil pero tinuloy mo pa rin, it still becomes premeditated. Is that right, Prosecutor Alejo?
Yes, sir.
Can you help explain that? Hindi naman yun sa oras, di ba? Sa panahon yun na pwede kang tumigil.
Yes, sir. I usually po yung kapag, ang usual example given by the books is that where there is a fight between the, yes, the litigants, and then the other one went home or left the scene, and then yung oras po binibilang doon na pag bumalik siya, tapos bumalik siya doon, tapos pinatay niya yung tao, yun po kasi he was given sufficient time to think about it. Nagiging murder po yun kapag binigyan ng sufficient time na parang lumamig ang ulo niya, and then he still killed the person. That's parang premeditation na po yun, evident.
Tama.
Premeditation. Opo. Ngayon po yung kapag spur of the moment, yan, habang nag-aaway sila, tapos he decided to kill, yun po, homicide. Po yun. Opo.
Okay, so kung pupunta ka doon, and I don't want to narrate the facts again because napag-usapan na natin to, tsaka medyo alam na rin to ng taong bayan. Kung pupunta ka doon, madaling araw, papalabasin mo yung jail guard, papaluhurin mo, tatanggalan mo ng armas, gagalawin mo yung hard drive. Di ho ba? Tama yan, di ba? These are all facts which were already stated. Hindi naman ho siguro yun spur of the moment. Pinaluhod mo yung mga armed guards. Pinatay mo yung hard drive. Paano naging spur of the moment yun? Paano naging homicide yun, Yusek Orseo?
So the way the police officers conducted its operations, I'm not privy to that. And
that's in the report
it's
of the
about,
NBI.
It's about judgment, a procedure that is likely most addressed to the PNP, Your Honor, because I relied only on the records.
So, wala ba yun sa records ng NBI, Director Giran? Wasn't that in your report that pinalabas yung mga armed guards, yung jail guards natin, pinaluhod, ginalaw yung hard drive? Wasn't that was in your report? Naalala ko, we talked about that, hindi po ba?
It's included in the report.
So, are you saying, Yusek Orseo, yung facts na yun, wala sa report na nabasa mo?
But on my judgment, Your Honor, I think it's evidentiary matters that is best left to the discretion of the court, Your Honor. And
well, it was first to your discretion because ikaw yung nag-recommend, eh. So
yes,
ikaw muna yung nagkaroon ng discretion, di ba?
Yes, exactly, Your Honor. But I want to inform this honorable court that the resolution that I signed, dated May 29, has been actually not affirmed but adopted by the Regional Trial Court in Leyte to be in order, Your Honor, including my findings on the lack of evident premeditation.
Okay. Iba pa po yung korte, no? Of course, the court will probably accept the recommendation of the DOJ. You are the DOJ after all, no? Ang gusto kong malaman is yung recommendation mo, paano mo nakuha? Now, itong panel, ho, there were, how many of you who underwent this, lima kayong pumirma, pero may mga kasama pa ba kayong investigators who came up with all of this data? Or kayong lima lang po yan?
None, sir. We just relied on this report of the NBI.
Okay, so there were five of you with the NBI,
yes,
all pointing to the same thing, no? Pareho po yung inyong conclusion. Yusek Orseo, in your case, coming up with your report, ilan po kayo na gumawa ng review ng lahat po ng mga documents?
I have 5 lawyers in my office, Your Honor, that went through with the records, Your Honor.
All right. Are they also here?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. And yung limang abogado po natin at kayo po yung team. You're the team that decided on this?
That's right, Your Honor.
And were you unanimous in coming up with this conclusion?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. So, nakita nyo yung kaparehas nakita ng NBI, ng Prosecutor's Office, ng mga committee ng Senado, you came up with a totally different result. Iba po yung resulta na nakuha po ninyo. Ito po ba'y kinonsult po muna ninyo kay Secretary Aguirre, kay Director Giran, kay Prosecutor Alejo? Well, tapos na ba yung report natin? Our report was March 7. So actually, the Senate report was completed already, Chairman, no? Tapos na po yung Senate report natin. Before you released it, hindi ho kayo parang mag-second opinion naman tayo. Tanungin natin ulit, patawag natin si Prosecutor Alejo, patawag natin si Director Giran, patawag natin yung members of the committee or even the committee secretary to find out bakit ibang-iba yung ating resulta. Did you do that, Yusek Arceo?
Your Honor, we have a different procedure. First, we only rely on the records submitted by the panel prosecutors, and then as a reviewing undersecretary, you have to review the records. Any extraneous evidences outside of this report should not be included, Your Honor, including the Senate report, Your Honor, unless it was made part of the record of the case, Your Honor.
All right. So, sinasabi mo, binabaliwala mo yung Senate report, no? Honor, hindi mahalaga yun sa inyo.
I'm saying that only based on the record. If any documents is not that is not part of the record,
hindi nyo pwedeng gamitin.
Yes, Your Honor. All right. That's correct, Your Honor.
But the DOJ, original DOJ report, and the NBI report, and the PNP report, and the medical legal report, and the IAS report, they were all there. Nandun po lahat yun.
Your Honor.
And more or less, they all pointed to one thing. They all pointed to murder, to premeditation. Pero, paglabas nung sa inyo, homicide, tsaka walang evident premeditation. Tama po?
That's correct, Your Honor.
Okay. In your procedure, ito po ba'y ginagawa nyo unilaterally? Or do the other USECs and Secretary Gui, do they have to sign off on it?
No, Your Honor.
So, ikaw lang yan?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, inaako mo itong responsibilidad
yes,
ng,
correct, Your Honor.
Ng report na ito. Alright. Nung finally lumabas po ito, what did the fellow members of the DOJ say to you? Hindi ho nila sinabi, USEC or SEO. Oh, ibang-iba yung nasabi namin. Ibang-iba yung pinag-usapan sa mga hearing na narinig po ng publiko. Ibang-iba po yung NBI. And they are all part of the DOJ family, if I'm not mistaken. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, meron hong lumapit sa inyo at nagsabi, Yusek Roseo, bakit naman ganito to?
No, Your Honor. There is none.
Wala.
There is none.
Secretary Aguirre, did he ask you why is it so different from the reports?
None at all, Your Honor. He didn't even intervene in the draft of that resolution.
No, I'm talking after, post. Kasi,
even after, Your Honor.
Sorry?
Even after the issuance of my resolution, he didn't even called upon me to ask.
Nobody talked to you?
Nobody, Your Honor.
Okay, so wala mang nagtanong, your fellow USECs, other members, but you did find that nag-motion for reconsideration ng NBI.
I just heard it right now, Your Honor.
Oh, you just heard it right now?
Yes, exactly.
So hindi mo alam na nag-motion for reconsideration sila?
Because the motion for reconsideration is not normally filed in my office, but it's on a different undersecretary, Your Honor.
Alright. Anong ibig sabihin ng homicide instead of murder? So unang-una, it's non-bailable ang homicide. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
So ibig ko sabihin yan, lahat ng mga kinasuhan na dapat nakakulong, pending the case, pending the resolution of the case, they are out right now.
Yes, Your Honor.
Opo. And when they are out, they are free to do whatever they want to do.
That's correct, Your Honor.
That's correct, no? Sige, let me go to General De La Rosa. So, General, ano po ang status ng mga PNP officers and personnel who are involved in this case? Nasaan po sila ngayon?
Some of them, Your Honor, are assigned with the CIDG Region 12, and the others are back to Regional Maritime Unit in Region 8. Yun yung President assignment lang.
So, they're back, in short?
Yes, Your Honor.
Na parang wala pong nangyari?
Because they're restored to full duty status, Your Honor,
right.
After they have posted the bail. they are back to full duty status, so we can utilize them again as normal police officers.
May I pursue that point, Senator Bam, with your permission? Kasi may conflicting statements kayo sa media, no? Sabi ni Inspector General, deemed served na yung suspension of 4 months, kaya pwede na bumalik sa full duty status. Yan ang narinig namin sinabi mo noon, eh. Anyway, sabi naman ni Chief PNP, hindi totoo yon kasi under motion for reconsideration. So hindi pa sila nakaserve ng sentence, ng suspension.
Yes, Your Honor.
So pag na-deny yung motion for reconsideration in your office, file in your office, saka pa lamang sila magsa-serve.
Yes, Your Honor.
Or si Marcos, yes, in this case, ano. So sa ngayon, back to full duty status on the basis of what?
On the basis of the lifting of their leave of absence, since na-incarcerate sila, Your Honor.
So whenever a police personnel is incarcerated by virtue of a non-bailable offense, leave of absence ang kategory na
automatic, Your Honor, they are placed on leave of absence while ongoing yung kaso, Your Honor. Hindi pa naman sila
so, si Inspector General lang iyas, you spoke too soon when you said that kaya na balik, hindi rin statement, eh, is back to duty status. Kasi served na yung suspension for four months.
Clarify. Sige. My statement. I was asked, the procedure, Your Honor, once you watch the Chief PNP signed decision, pupunta po yung decision sa DPRA for
so
implementation.
So, has already approved your recommendation?
Yes, sir. Then, pupunta po yung sa DPRM para iserve po yung copy.
Yes, implementation. Execution, okay po, yun, eh.
But,
so, hindi ba late na yung motion for reconsideration considering that the Chief PNP has already signed or approved the resolution of IAS?
No, procedure. No, sir. The motion for reconsideration can be filed only after the within 10 days after they receive the copy of the decision.
Okay.
Okay. Now, yung sa media naman ng aking tanong, that is hypothetical question. Kasi sinasabi nila, ilan ba po yung penalty ni Marcos? Sabi ko, 4 months. So, kung na-implement po yon, hindi ko naman alam na nag-file ng motion or nag-file appeal kasi ang mag-resolve po noon ang DPRM. So, ina-assume ko lang na during that time, pwede na po sila kasi otherwise they will be charged for a whole if they will not report back to duty once the expirations of the four months period.
Okay. So, General, yung mga people who involved dito, including Superintendent Marcos, they are back to regular duty. They are working. They are on the field again. Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Is that usual? Normal po ba yun na kapag may police na kinasuhan, nag-bail, ay ibabalik na to normal duty? Or usually po ba, fino-floating ba yun, nialagay sa ibang lugar? Hindi ho yung binabalik mismo sa field at binabalik to regular duty. O normal po yun? Lahat po ba ng mga may kaso na naka-bail, balik lang kaagad po sila sa pagtatrabaho po nila?
Technically, Your Honor,
they can.
Yeah, they can. Your Honor,
but usually, is that usual? Ganun ho ba yun usually kapag merong police involved in a very controversial case na downgrade nga because of the recommendation of the DOJ homicide, and of course, there are agencies and bodies that see it as murder. Normal po ba yun na ibabalik siya right there at the front line, dun mo po mismo kung saan pwede hong gawin po ito ulit? Normal po ba yun?
Not so normal, Your Honor.
Oh, so bakit ho na? That was your decision po, di ba? Na i-reinstate po sila.
Again, Your Honor, let me correct you. That's not a reinstatement, Your Honor. Reassignment.
Oh, reassignment. Okay. Kasi ibang region na, no? But that was your decision po, General.
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, bakit hindi nyo lang ho nag-decide na, oh, anyway, may kaso itong mga to, they're on bail, ilagay natin muna sa opisina. holding group or kung ano man, nangyayari naman yan, di ba? May mga floating status or you assign them to office sa opisina muna para ma-monitor po yung mga gawain. Bakit po sila ibabalik doon po mismo sa field kung saan yung last na pinanggalingan nila, may pinatay sila?
Your Honor, kapag nag-uusap po kami ni Presidente, he's always intimating to me na pag okay na yung sila si Marcos, sayang yung sweldo natin dyan sa kanila, patrabahuin mo na yan.
So yung statement po na yon, hindi ho kayo yung nagsabi nun, si Presidente po nagsabi nun?
Ganun, Your Honor. And he's keep on saying in the media na ibabalik niya si Marcos sa trabaho.
General, earlier, kakasabi niyo lang po, walang epekto yung mga media pronouncements po ni President Duterte sa gawain po ninyo. Are you changing your answer? Meron po nga bang epekto ang mga media pronouncements ni Presidente o wala?
As far as the decision of their case, Your Honor, there was no influence yung media pronouncement ni Presidente, Your Honor. But as far as the reassignment back to CIDG full duty assignment, Your Honor, palagi sinasabi ni Presidente na gamitin yung mga tao niyan. Sayang, we lack people on the ground, sumusweldo yung mga tao niyan, patrabahoin ninyo.
Do you lack people on the ground?
Yes, Your Honor.
Kulang ho kayo ng mga police, ng operatives?
Kulang, Your Honor.
So are you saying, General, na kung kayo lang, hindi nyo po ibabalik silang Superintendent Marcos sa field?
Ibabalik ko pa rin, Your Honor, dahil maraming trabaho, Your Honor.
Okay, so babalik po ako sa tanong ko. Usual po ba yun na may kaso, government agencies, no? Ang NBI, ang NAPROS, ang Senate, nagsabi na ang mga pulis na ito gumawa ng masamang bagay. Normal po ba na ibalik sila sa field? Kung yun po yung magiging decision po ninyo.
As I have said, not so normal, Your Honor.
Okay, pero gagawin mo pa rin.
Ba't ginagawa ko, Your Honor?
And you stand by this decision na i-reinstate siya, ibalik sa field?
Yes, Your Honor.
Alright. Sa totoo lang, General, no, sobra kaming na-shock kaming lahat dito nung firstly, nung na-downgrade, no? That was a big shock. Pero I think the bigger shock was the move to reinstate na parang walang nangyari, no? After all the hearings that we've had here, in fact, si Chairman nga po, na-quote ka, napamura bigla, kundi ako nagkakamali, no? And that's not usual. Hindi ho yun usual kay Chairman. And what signal does this send, no? Ano pong senyales ang nasi-send po nito sa taong bayan at sa members of the PNP? Kasi ho, ang lumalabas po kasi, kahit gumawa ka ng mali, hindi lang po yan payanaw ng Senado, payanaw po yan ng mga ahensya ng gobyerno who are all part of the executive as well. Kung gumawa ka ng mali, as long as okay ka sa mga nasa taas, babalik ka rin na parang walang nangyari. That's the signal that's being sent, no, to the public. Can you comment on that?
Siguro, Your Honor, kung na-convict talaga sa court at ibinalik natin, mukhang merong bad signal. Pero yung ganun na dumaan sila sa proseso, nakapag-bail ban sila, nakulong na nga sila. Pagkakulong nila, nabago yung na-downgrade from murder to homicide, nakapos lang ng bail bond, they are back in full duty status. I think kung titingnan natin naman doon sa, kung ina-afford natin yan sa ordinary criminal, yung ganong proseso, Your Honor, siguro naman sa ordinary yung police din na pwede rin natin ibigay, Your Honor. So, pag sinasabi mo na yung, again, I have to jump in your, yung statement, Your Honor, that is leading towards impunity, Your Honor, ang ibig mong sabihin, hindi po mangyayari yan, Your Honor.
Well, kayo nagsabi nun, no?
I'm sure you will follow up that statement, Your Honor, yung mga impunity na yan. So, unahan na lang kita.
Ano po bang ibig sabihin ng impunity? Impunity is kapag tuloy-tuloy yung paggawa ng
para
masama.
Para bang kuha na sila, Your Honor, yung wala na silang...
Kumbaga, above the law na sila.
Para bang above the law na sila na wala na silang pakialam, basta they can do whatever they want. Hindi po mangyayari yan sa akin, Your Honor. I will do everything to stop impunity.
Alam mo, General, no? Ako naman, I've said this many times. Ako naniniwala naman ako mabubuting tao yung nasa PNP. Pero there are times na kailangan manindigan tayo dun sa tingin nating tama kahit unpopular or kahit may mababangga tayo. In this case, isang tao lang naman ho to, isang grupo to. Hindi ko maintindihan why you are risking the credibility of the whole police force for these individuals na para po sa amin dito, yung nasa kaliwa, yung nasa kanan at dito po sa harap, napakalinaw naman na gumawa sila ng masamang bagay, nag-murder po sila. So hindi ko maintindihan kung bakit kayo, why are you risking everything for Superintendent Marcos and his group, no? Now, tanungin ko po, last question po, Chairman. Ito pong pag-reinstate kay Superintendent Marcos, ito po ba ay naging nakataas ba ito o nakababa ng moral sa ating PNP?
Nakakataas po ng moral, Your Honor.
Bakit po?
Because the President is a man of his words. Sinabi niya na pag kayo'y magka-problema sa trabaho ninyo, andito ako, babakapan ko kayo, hindi ko kayo pabayaan. And yung ginawa po lang ni Superintendent Marcos, that was in line of duty, Your Honor. So, tinulungan siya na tinutulungan si Superintendent Marcos na patrabahoin uli, Your Honor. So, makakahimoral po pag ganun.
So, pag nagkaroon ng problema, may tutulong. Yung problema, tama o mali, doesn't matter. Or, problema lang pero nasa tama ka. O problema kahit nasa mali ka, tutulungan ka pa rin.
Well, sa amin sa police, Your Honor, sa nakikita namin sa yung umaayaw ay yung hindi na gusto niya ginagawa namin, wala na kaming nagagawang tama, puro mali yung nakikita nila sa amin. So we must as well be ready to seek the help of the President pag ganun palagi ang sitwasyon, Your Honor.
Okay. Final question, General, no? Yung dito po sa kaliwa, tingin po nila murder. Dito po sa kanan, tingin po nila murder. Dito po sa harap, tingin po namin murder yan. Si Jose Corseo, tingin niya homicide, no? To be fair. Kayo po, ang tingin niyo po ba, this was a regular police operation and walang ginawang mali si Superintendent Marcos, hence binabalik niyo siya sa CIDG 12 or ilalagay niyo siya sa CIDG 12 or merong unusual, merong abnormal, meron pong masamang nangyari dun sa pagpatay kay Mayor Espinosa?
We believe that merong hindi magandang nangyayari doon, Your Honor. Kaya nga, sinuspende natin siya. Ang kasamahan niya, dinimote natin one rank demotion. That I signed that resolution, Your Honor, na i-demote sila. May liability sila, Your Honor. So that is why dinesisyon namin ganun. But,
hanggang doon na?
But, Your Honor, yung pagbalik sa kanila doon sa pwesto, ibang usapan na po yun. Technically, they can be deployed anywhere because they're in full duty status. And I see the order of the President na sabi niya na trabahuin mo na yan, isaya yung sweldo ng mga tao niya sa sweldo, walang ginagawa, lugi ang gobyerno, patrabahuin mo na yan. I see no reason for me not to obey the orders of the President, Your Honor.
All right. Salamat po, General. Thank you.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Thank you, Senator Bang. Let's go back in time, ano, and review some issuances. First, DOJ Department Order Circular 70, Series 2000 ito, issued by then Secretary of Justice Artemio Toquero. Ang sinasabi rito, yung rule on appeal. And then subsequently, he issued Department Circular Number 70-A. Ito, delegation of authority to regional state prosecutors. Okay, malinaw yon, di ba? Yung petition for review, ito'y dinedelegate ni dating Secretary Toquero sa mga regional state prosecutors. Now comes Secretary Aguirre, naglabas siya ng Department Circular Number 003, dated July 1, 2016. Ang sinasabi naman doon, ang delegation, binago niya from regional state prosecutors, binigay niya sa mga undersecretaries. Actually, niname niya actually yung mga undersecretaries na pwedeng mag-conduct ng petition for review. And you're one of them, ano? Namely, Yusek Eric Balmes, Raymond Mecate, Yusek Reynante Orseo, Yusek Deo Marco. Okay. Subsequent to that, naglabas siya ng
DOJ Circular Number 19. Ang sinasabi dito, ito maliwanag, ano? Coverage 1.1, yung sa paragraph ito. These implementing guidelines, hereinafter referred to as guidelines, shall cover petitions for review filed from July 1, 2016 until December 31, 2016. All motions for reconsideration filed within the same period regardless of the date of petitions of petition for review and all cases under automatic review, close parenthesis, or open parenthesis, violations of the comprehensive, etc., etc. Only. Naka-highlight pa yung only. In short, ang pwede lang imbisigahan or ang covered ng Department Order 003, Department Circular, nahahawakan ng mga undersecretaries, lahat ng petitions for review filed during that inclusive period. Tanong, since yung finding, yung information na na-file ng panel of prosecutors, March 2, 2017. So, hindi po probable or sabihin ko na imposible na yung petition for review na i-file within July 1, 2016 hanggang December 31, 2016. So, my question is, would that invalidate your resolution downgrading murder to homicide? Kasi hindi covered nung Department Circular yung hindi sakop o hindi saklaw nung period, kasi 2017 na ninyo ginawa, o presumably hindi natin alam kung kailan nag-file ng petition for review unless you have in your records kung kailan nag-file ng petition for review. But definitely it could not have been before March 2 of 2017. Kasi hindi pa naman na-file yung information. So would that render invalid the resolution issued by Undersecretary Reynante Orseo?
Let me check first the issue, the honor.
Actually, wala sa website nyo itong Circular Number 19. Nahanap namin, hindi namin makita. Kaya lang, my staff are very resourceful. Nakakuha kami ng kopya, kaya nakita namin na yung palang covered period eh labas doon sa, or hindi pasok doon sa ginawa niyong resolution sa inyong petition for review.
Since this is a department circular, it's supposed to be an internal matter within the DOJ, unless it is a department order, Your Honor.
So what you're saying is this is not valid?
No, what I'm saying is that since it is not
published, so you are in violation of Department Circular number 19?
No, Your Honor.
Hindi, you clarify. Ang sinasabi malinaw eh. Kailan nakakaalam?
Yes, Your Honor.
Eh, nasa website nyo eh, nakapost.
The Department Circular, Your Honor?
Yeah, yung 19 nga nawawala eh. Pero lahat nakapost dito sa website ninyo.
I have to check on that, Your Honor.
Hindi, I'm telling you already. Department Circular 17, 18, 20. Nawala yung 19. Yung pa naman ang importante kasi yun yung mayroong period covered. In other words, hindi ka authorized magsagawa ng petition for review or mag-resolve ng petition for review do sa mga kaso na na-file o sa mga petition na na-file outside of that period. So ang tanong ko, and this is a legal question, and maybe PG or acting PG Catalan can help me out, ano? Kasi walang lawyer din sa amin tatlo, wala sina Dick Gordon, wala din sina Senator Drilon, ano, to help us out. So magtanong na lang kami sa lawyers. Would that render invalid the resolution issued by USEC? I'm not trying to put you on the spot or anybody on the spot for that matter. We're after the truth, ano? Hindi namin kayo pinag-aaway dito. Kanina, bisita ko si Director Geran. Sabi niya, sir, baka pag-away-awayin mo kami dun. No, that's not the purpose. Ano? We're here to ferret out the truth. Do we want to put on the spot the panel of prosecutors and the NBI investigators. Kasi yung kanilang findings run counter do sa
finding ng Undersecretary of Justice no less. So, PG Catalan,
good morning, Mr.
ano
Chairman.
Yung legal opinion nyo pagka ganyan? Merong department circular, anong effect noon sa resolution na in-issue ng Undersecretary Orseo?
Yeah. Good morning, Mr. Chairman. Your Honors, I just want to make it on record that I was designated as acting Prosecutor General only last June 13 of this year.
Yeah,
so
I'm trying to elicit your opinion as a resource person and as a lawyer in good standing and as an acting Prosecutor General. So I'm looking at you as a competent resource person to give us a sensible legal opinion.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. Since, Mr. Chairman, there is a resolution to the matter or designation, irrespective, I think, of the period, I think the principle of regularity in the performance, Your Honor, would come in this. Anyway, I think the rationale or purpose.
The much abused presumption of regularity in the performance of duty.
There is, I think, Your Honor, a purpose or rationale in this. Because there are, I think, a thousand petition for abuse pending with the Department of Justice. And there are also cases which are pending with the court, especially those cases which have not yet been arraigned. So we have to come up with an immediate resolution of the matter because under the rules, the litigants are given 60 days, or the court is given 60 days within which to arraign upon motion of the a litigant, Your Honor. He will just move for the delay of the arraignment because there is a pending petition for review with the Department of Justice.
In this case, Sina Marcos hindi pa na-arraign, di ba? Kaya pwede pa talagang mag-file ng petition for review. Pag na-arraign na, hindi na pwede mag-file ng petition for review, hindi ba?
Yes, Your Honor. Although there is no prohibition on the matter, but usually the court would
deny
the resolution of the Department of Justice and go ahead with the trial of the case.
Another question kay Yusek Orseo. When was the petition for review filed and who filed it? Do you have a copy of the petition?
Your Honor, the petition for review was filed on April 5, 2017.
Let me acknowledge the presence of the other vice chairperson, Senator Grace Po. Good morning, ma'am. Please proceed.
Honor, it was filed on April 5, 2017. The same party in the complainant itself, Your Honor.
Marcos.
Yes. No. The petitioner. Yes, Your Honor. The respondents, et al. Marcos et al. Your Honor.
Sila lahat.
Yes, sir.
April 5.
You know, going back to the DC circular issued by the department, there was a previous circular number 003 dated January 4, 2017, wherein there is no time bound as to when we can resolve cases on petition for review and automatic review. And the one that the chair mentioned about DC number 19, there is a paragraph here, coverage under paragraph, subparagraph 1.3. which I quote, for purposes of existing petitions for review covered by these guidelines, existing department orders and other assignments made by the secretary shall remain applicable unless the same are revoked. You know, I believe undersecretaries are still authorized to resolve cases on automatic review and petitions for review, Your Honor, considering these two department circulars that has been issued by the secretary.
Yeah, pero malinaw doon sa implementing guidelines eh. Nang nag-issue, Secretary Aguirre rin eh.
Yes, Your Honor, but
nilimit. Di ba? Nilimit yung period eh.
But there is, Your Honor, there is a paragraph, sub-paragraph 1.3.
Saan?
Under the same, DC-19, Your Honor. Coverage, under the headings coverage, 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3, page 1, Your Honor.
Oh, sinasabi lang dito, 1.3?
Yes, Your Honor.
For purposes of resolving petitions for review covered by these guidelines, existing department orders and other assignments made by the secretary shall remain applicable unless the same are revoked.
Yes, Your Honor. And so, this existing guidelines is covered by DC 003 dated January 4, 2017, Your Honor.
Yeah, 003, yun yung circular, guidelines sa disposition. Pero yung Department Circular 19, yun ang implementing guidelines. Doon, kinwalify further na ang pwede lang na subject ng petition for review to be handled by the undersecretary's name under 003. Yun nga, from July 1, 2016 to December 31, 2016. Malinaw yun eh. Yung petition for review mo, April 5, ifinile, 2017. And April 5, 2017 is not within the inclusive period of July 1, 2016 up to December 31, 2016. That's my point.
I'll take note of that, Your Honor, but then I'll abide on the subparagraph 1.3 of DC-19.
Wala naman sinasabi sa 1.3.
Existing department circulars are still in effect, Your Honor, and that includes DC number 003.
Pero effectively revoked na nga yun ng 019 eh.
There is a collateral here unless the same are revoked.
Where is the revocation?
And revocation since there was no revocation of this one, and in fact the subject of this 19 is state implementing guidelines and further clarifications on department.
Kaya nga kinlarify, nilimit niya yung authority ninyo na mag-conduct ng petition for review within the period specified under 019. July 1, 2016 hanggang December 31. Ni-revoke niya ba yon? Hindi ah.
No, it's not, Your Honor.
Oh. But eh kaya nga, tanong ko nga kanina sa mga lawyers na nandito, including kay Acting PG, valid ba yung ginawa mong resolution? Kasi it's in violation of, hindi sakop noong period na nasa circular. So, pagka ganun, sa tingin ko, coming from a layman, illegal yung act mo. Di ba? And when ang result ng act mo hindi valid kasi illegal yung act. Tama ba yan as a lawyer?
Well, academically, that's correct, Your Honor.
Theoretically?
Theoretically, Your Honor.
Your Honor, may I ask a question?
Sige, sige.
Any lawyer can help us, even you, si Corseo. Kung hindi nga po valid, let's assuming hypothetically hindi po valid yung petition for review ni yung resolution no ng DOJ. Kung hindi ho yun valid, ano hong mangyayari? Will can the court still say that the information they received was not valid and therefore they can still change their mind? Maybe PG Catalan, maybe you can help us.
Well, Your Honor, assuming that the said circular department order would be declared as invalid, a motion to quash would therefore be filed with the court, and definitely the court.
Not the department the circular, but the resolution.
Yes.
At the resolution.
Invalid.
That is with the assumption, Your Honor, that it is invalid.
Okay.
Of course, it is incumbent for the judge to...
Well, it's no longer an assumption because it's covered by department circulars, 003 and 019. Kaya hindi pwedeng sabihin natin assumption because nasa black and white eh.
we can probably make a further study on whether or not it is invalid, Your Honor.
Yeah, I'm wondering, kasi in this case, the DOJ, kumbaga trabaho kasi ng prosecutor, dapat yung murder, di ba? Pero yung DOJ nagsabi, baba mo to homicide. Let's say that that resolution was invalid, what would be the next steps? Would the prosecutor in this case make another resolution to the judge to say that the initial information provided was invalid? Is there such a procedure? May ganun procedure ba?
But foremost, Your Honor, is for the judge to quash the or dismiss the case on the ground that the resolution emanating from the information is not or is defective. So a motion has to be filed within with the court. But then, Your Honor, we cannot now immediately declare the invalidity or illegality of the said resolution because
before I recognize Senator Pono, para may closure, magbigyan ng closure itong issue na ito. Tanong ko na lang sa panel of prosecutors, can you now file a motion to quash doon sa court? Yung resolution, yung case. Yung resolution ng to reconsider yung pag-downgrade from murder to homicide on the basis of this.
Sir, because they were already arraigned on homicide, so the prosecution service already divested of its authority and I think it will be addressed by the courts already, if ever.
Hindi nga, kaya nga, sa court kayo mag-motion. Hindi ba pwede yun?
The problem, sir, is that they were already arraigned
on sa homicide.
Yes, Your Honor. And filing again an information for murder would really affect the substantially their rights, Your Honor.
So, anong remedy? Anyway, balikan na lang natin mamaya. I'll recognize muna si Senator po.
Perhaps, Your Honor, a motion to withdraw the information filed for homicide. But, and then again, it will be upon the discretion of the court if they will grant the said motion.
Maraming salamat po. Mr. Chair, actually yung aking tanong, ang implikasyon nito hindi lamang sa liderato ng PNP. Unang-una nakita natin yung nangyari pero biglang napatawad na reinstate sa trabaho. Ang gusto natin is to maintain independence in the PNP but especially also in the DOJ for our state prosecutors. Nakita natin ang rekomendasyon ng IAS, ng NBI, at First Prosecutors Panel na murder lahat. And then with one different opinion na overturn ito sa homicide, but the implication of that is more than just overturning the decision. Particularly with examples being set in the DOJ. Bakit? Kamustahin natin, Mr. Chair, itong si Fiscal Alejo. Fiscal Alejo, nasaan po kayo?
Nasaan po?
What are the possible reasons that the prosecutor up for promotion will not be promoted? Now, is it true that you're up for promotion? How about the other members of your panel? Despite these, I hope that you will answer my question candidly. Are you affected? Kayo ba'y naapektuhan ng inyong unang desisyon na murder, tapos na overturn? Mukha yatang binabalikan kayo.
I think po, personally, na not all. Kasi po, nasanay naman po kami. Like, ako po, 23 years na po ako sa serbisyo. Nasanay na din po naman kami na nire-reverse minsan po ng Secretary of Justice pag nag-a-appeal yung aming mga resolutions po.
Okay, I understand now the tone that you have. Okay. So you're up for promotion, is that true?
I just applied for a position which was created by the National Prosecution Act in the year 2010, which up to now, hindi pa po na-fill up ever.
2010 pa po, meron kakulangan, may bakante doon, hindi pa rin kayo napopromote?
Actually po yun, hindi pa po na-fill up ever since na na-create siya ng National Prosecution Act.
Okay, so wala. Ngayon, gusto kong tanungin itong mga kasama natin, ha, kung totoo ito. Senior Deputy State Prosecutor Theodore Villanueva na-assign sa Guimaras, tapos nilipat sa Malolos. Prosecutor Villanueva, nandito ba?
Wala po siya.
Wala siya dito. Richard Fadulion to Guimaras. Ngayon, binalik sa DOJ main office. Si Miguel Gudyo sa Compostela Valley. But Gudyo is now holding office, and what task forces, if any, is he in charge of? City Prosecutor Ed Tongo ng Manila under preventive suspension, and Alex Ramos Talyones was designated OIC. Is this normal practice in the DOJ? How many times is a prosecutor usually reassigned, and for what reasons? Yung mga nasa unang desisyon na murder, yung naging findings, kamusta na po yung mga prosecutor na yan, kasama na kayo?
So far, okay naman po. Wala naman po kasi even before or during the time that we handled the investigation of the case, the preliminary investigation, wala naman pong pasabi or advice or any other influence. Wala naman po.
Okay. Pero sa tingin ninyo, ha, yung IAS, Attorney Triambulo, you still stand on your decision na talagang dapat murder itong kaso na to?
Yes po, ma'am. Not on the premeditation, no, but on the superior strength. Because there are many qualified circumstances under the revised penal code to make it murder.
Ito nga yung aking kinalulungkot. Kaya nga tayo may internal affairs office to maintain independence. And I'm masaya ako, Attorney Triambulo, na naninindigan kayo dito. Sapagkat yan nga yung ating tinutulak, magkaroon ng independence ng PNP. Hindi pwedeng dahil lamang sa isang desisyon ng kung sino ay marireverse lahat ng inyong findings. E paano kayo magkakaroon ng lakas loob? Kayo, PNP Chief De La Rosa, yung personal ninyong pananaw, tama ba naman yung nangyari doon?
Saan pangyari, ma'am? Yung pagpatay?
Yung nangyaring operasyon, yung pagpatay, etc.
Hindi po tama, ma'am. Kaya nga, penalize natin sila, ma'am. One rank demotion yung mga aktual na kasama sa loob. 4 months suspension si Superintendent Marcos, and others were given penalties, ma'am.
Opo. So, kayo mismo, naniniwala na sa personal ninyong pananaw, walang technical na anong paman na pwede silang ma-reinstate. Sa tingin nyo, hindi tama yon at hindi magandang ehemplo yon, hindi ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, so sabihin na natin na hindi siya na-dismiss. Yung reinstate ba naman ninyo na OIC pa rin doon ng CIDG? Ano ba naman yon? Wala na kayong ibang makuha?
Your Honor, I am trained to follow orders, Your Honor.
So who gave you the orders to reinstate him in that particular position?
The President always intimated to me whenever we talk. He said that kung pwede nang patrabahuin yung mga tao niyan, kung wala nang nagbabar sa'yo, patrabahuin mo na yan. Kasi sayang sumusweldo yung mga tao na yan, yung pera ng gobyerno, sweldo nila, tapos wala silang ginagawa.
Hindi, patrabahuin mo na. Abay, talaga namang dapat pagtrabahuan nila yung sweldo nila. Eh, yun nga lang, maraming balakid na legal. Pero ito yung tanong ko sa inyo, intimated to you, so did he particularly say, reinstate him in the position as OIC of the CIDG. In that particular area, Region 8? Region 12.
Time, Your Honor, yung sinabi niya na pagtrabahoin mo, nagbalik yung mga tao na yan, they're in full duty status. Then, I talked to the director of CIDG, ano bang kwan, ano bang bakante dyan na pwede mong lalagyan itong tao na ito dahil papagtrabahoin natin. He told me that babakante daw yung kwan, yung CIDG 12. So sabi ko, sige, ilagay mo doon para magtrabaho na balik yan.
Yung dati niyang posisyon, saan siya?
CIDG 8, Your Honor.
So sa 8 siya, tapos nalipat sa 12.
After incarceration, Your Honor. After nakapag-bilban na sila.
Pero same function, different location. Tama po ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Alam ko na nga yan eh. Yun yung problema kasi nakita na natin may pagkakamali. Oo, nagkaroon ng suspension. Pero binibigyan mo pa rin ng parehong responsibilidad dun sa lugar na yun. Hindi yan matututo ng leksyon. Ganun pa rin. At siguro, mas walang habas na kung sakasakaling lalakas ang loob niyan. Kaya nga po, sa tingin ko naman ang ating Pangulo ay makikinig sa yung mismong mga rekomendasyon. Kahit na sabi mo, pinapakinggan mo, syempre, Commander-in-Chief yan. Natural lamang sa'yo yon. Papakinggan nyo, pero naniniwala ako, kumpiyansya siya sa'yo. So kung sinabi mo, Mr. President, hindi siguro maganda muna. Alam ko, nagsumisweldo yan. Bigyan natin ng ibang trabaho. Ba't natin bibigyan niya ng posisyon na liderato?
On my part naman, Your Honor, I take it as a challenge na pag binigyan ko ng chance itong tao na ito magtrabaho, then gumagawa naman ng kalokohan, then ako naman nalagot yan, Your Honor. Please give me one more chance. Pag gumawa pa ito ng kalokohan, I will take it personally against him, Your Honor.
So, let me just make it clear, mas malinaw lang po to. Kayo po ay hindi nagrekomenda sa presidente na wag munang bigyan ng assignment ito na katulad niyan.
Well, napag-usapan naman, Your Honor, na I really point out the pointed out to him na mukhang mainit pa yung issue, sir. Baka pwedeng kuha lang muna. Maya na. And he told me, every time lalabas siya sa media, Your Honor, sige siya sabi na pabalikin yan, patrabaho niyan, balik-balik ganun. So magkita kami, may flight. Sayang yung mga tao niya, walang ginagawa. So, ako naman, Your Honor, I take it as an order from my boss. Although hindi niya directly sinasabi na ilagay mo doon, pabalikin mo ganito, but I'm just taking hints from his pronouncement, Your Honor. So, well, I talked to the director of CIDG. Kung walang nagbabar sa atin, technically, walang nagbabar sa atin na i-reassign natin ito sa ganitong pwesto, then patrabahoin natin. Pag ito pa'y gumawa ng another kalokohan, Your Honor, if you term it as kalokohan, I will take it personally against him.
Eh, ba't di mo ilagay sa HPG muna?
Mas posibleng may kwan doon, Your Honor. Pareho lang rin yun na kung gusto mo talaga mangutong, gusto mo talaga magluko, kung kahit anong assignment mo, Your Honor, makakagawa ka.
Eh, kaya nga. Eh, pero mas lalo na dun sa direktang may magagawa kay Highway Patrol, eh. Sino
Senator
naman ang... yes, sorry.
Sabi mo, pag gumawa pa ulit, may nakakulong bang mayor doon sa Sok Sarjan?
Hinahanap pa, Your Honor.
Anyway, thank you, Senator.
Oh, sige. So, siguro... So ito yung malinaw na natutunan ko dito. Unang-una, na sumusunod ka lang ng sa tingin mong gusto ng Pangulo, pero hindi mo naman binigyan ng talagang technical na strategiya kung paano mare-reform itong tao na to, kung saan muna ilalagay. Iniisip lang ninyo, may bakante doon, sayang sumisweldo. Siguro, importante talaga na kahit na siyempre Commander-in-Chief mo yung Pangulo, nakita naman natin napakahalaga ng iyong rekomendasyon. Sa tingin ko, pakikinggan ka nun. Pero maraming salamat din sa IAS. Bigyan nyo naman ng konting suporta yung IAS kasi kung ano na yung rekomendasyon eh, tapos ma-overturn lang, eh bakit pa yan gaganahan sa trabaho? Siguro talagang dapat ma-review natin itong kapangyarihan ng IAS as mas palakasin pa.
For the record, Your Honor, wala pa akong binago doon sa recommendation ng IAS. Kung ano yung na-recommend niya na decision for that particular case, I sign it wholeheartedly, Your Honor. Hindi ko pa yung binago.
So yung DOJ lang talaga yung nagkaroon ng ibang desisyon, yung ating prosecutor. Baka naman pwede, ito ah, totoo ba na yung mga ibang fiscal sa Luzon bigla na lang nailipat sa Mindanao involuntarily? Meron bang dahilan? Meron ba silang mga kaso na dahil dito sa nangyari?
Uh,
Good morning po ulit, Your Honor. Totoo naman po na may mga nalipat po sa ibang estasyon. Kagaya po ng sinabi nyo, yung mga pangalan po nila ay totoo naman po. At inaalaw naman po ito ng Section 19 ng National Prosecution Service na they can be transferred sa assignment po sa ibang estasyon. Although, it must not exceed 3 months. And kung pong mag-exceed ng 3 months, the consent has to be given in writing po.
Ngayon, pero I'd like to know, sir, my question is this. From the original panel that gave the decision of murder, meron ba sa kanila nang na-transfer sa ibang lugar o na-demote o tinakot?
Wala naman po, Your Honor.
O takot kayo ngayon?
Wala naman po.
Kasi unang-una, ma'am, paki-explain lang ha. Pero i-explain ninyo ito, not so much so that the lawyers can understand your legal point of view, pero para sa ating mga kababayan, bakit ninyo minabuti o bakit ninyo pinili na dapat murder at hindi homicide? Paki-explain po yung dalawang diferensya nun sa maiintindihan ng ating mga kababayan. Bakit dapat murder? And do you stand by that decision?
Yes po, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Please go ahead and educate us. And that will be my last question, Mr. Chair.
Okay, ma'am. Kasi po, ma'am, unang-una po, yung pagkakasecure po ng search warrant, kasi po parang para sa panel po sa amin, parang ang tingin po namin napaka-irregular. Kasi po, nandun na po sila sa loob ng isang government facility, detention facility, and yet kailangan mo pa mag-secure ng search warrant. Eh, kapag po naman nakakulong ay isang tao at any time of the day, pwede naman po silang puntahan ng mga authorities doon sa detention center at inspekin po kung ano yung mga nilalaman o kung anong ginagawa nila doon sa kulungan nila. Ngayon po, kapag hindi po naman ganun ang mangyayari, ibig sabihin lang po, hindi competent or hindi efficient itong mga authorities doon sa detention center. Bakit mo pa kinakailangan ng mag-issue ng search warrant? Ngayon po, pangalawa po, tungkol po doon sa evident premeditation. Nagkaroon po kami ng findings for evident premeditation kasi po, nagkaroon naman po ng briefing bago naman po nangyari itong insidente na ito. Although, ine-emphasize po ni Colonel Marcos na ang sabi niya, wala daw masasaktan at walang mamamatay, something like that. And then, we found also for treachery kasi po, although ang sabi sa search warrant at any time of the day or night, alas tres po ng madaling araw, government detention facility po yan. Siguro naman po, wala naman pong untoward incident na mangyayari sa isang government detention facility na kinakailangan mo pa pong mag-search ng madaling araw po, alas tres. Tapos po, we also find that treachery nga po yun. Tapos yung dami po ng personnel na pumasok. Una, they had to force their way in to the point of destroying the locks of the jail. And then, they had to remove the arms of this augmentation team. Ito pong augmentation team, mga kabaro po nila ito galing from the Philippine National Police. So siguro, nagtataka lang po kami sa halip na sabihin nila, tulungan nyo kami, baka may totoong may baril dyan or what, tulungan nyo kami. Dinisarm po sila, tapos pina-face the wall to the point that one of them urinated in his pants sa takot po dahil nakatutok yung baril sa kanila. And then there were two teams, the other one securing yung parang outer perimeter, and then yung the other one, sila yung pumasok sa loob. Tapos po, based also on the statement of an inmate na nakita niya na mag-thumbs down yung isang police officer, nandun po yung burst ng gunfire. So parang orchestrated na po siya talaga. And then also on the basis of the sworn statement of Colonel Marcos admitting to the fact that he was just around the vicinity coordinating with his men. Kino-coordinate po niya yun while the incident was happening. So we had no recourse but to say that there was conspiracy po. Plus the fact that the basis of the search warrant po, yung kay Mr. Olendan, sabi niya, nung itong date na ito, na andun ako, nakita ko nagre-repack ng shabu, may barel, eh on that particular date po, na nag-execute ng judicial affidavit, yung isang assistant principal ng Leyte National High School, which is more than 100 kilometers away from the facility, saying that he was there, dahil parang he was hired as a janitor or a carpenter, he was doing something, and yung ano po niya doon, attendance, biometrics. So, hindi po mapwedeng faking yun na ng attendance. Yung di, ibig sabihin po na nagsisinungaling siya nung sinabi niya na nagpunta siya doon. That's why we recommended that an information for perjury be filed against him. Because yung pong, tapos yung mga kasamahan niyang nagkakarpintero also testified to the fact that he was with them on that particular time and day of the day and that particular day. And then this assistant principal saying that it is highly improbable that he could drop by the jail facility because that's more than 100 kilometers away. So, parang ang lumalabas po, parang na-orchestrate na pagplanuhan, hence there was evident premeditation and there was treachery dahil in the guise na pagpasok mo doon, bakit mo naman didisarmahan yung, sa totoo lang, kabaro mo sila eh, dapat tutulungan kanila, their augmentation team, di po ba? And then you have to destroy. And in the matter also of the removal of the CCTVs, from what we understood, that there were CCTVs functioning because according to the sworn statement of the jail guards, that they saw the patrol cars coming through the CCTV. So it means
excuse
that
me,
the CCTV was working
SSP Alejo, I just hope that Yusek Orseo is listening to your narration of facts. You know? Kasi iba yung appreciation niya ng facts. Eh. That's the reason why he downgraded murder to homicide. And as an aside, you know, I'd like to state here that we take our hat off no, to you and the members of the panel prosecutors for being very professional. No, and you have remained professional up to this very moment, no, even if you are in front of high officials of the DOJ. No, you're still standing your ground and defending your information, no, yung information that you filed with the bye-bye RTC.
Mr. Chair, I think a good signal that the DOJ can give here, a good message, is to actually promote her for something that's already been available since 2010. That would be...
we will request Yusek Orseo to talk to Secretary Aguirre to promote you.
Yes, and I know this is my last question. First, let me thank you, ma'am, for clarifying it for us, all of that. Yung pati yung tawag na magpadala na kayo ng soko dito, hindi pa nga nangyayari, di ba?
Yes,
parang may
yes,
mga ganong kwento. So, before I end, at Attorney Lemos of the NBI, you stand by your decision that it's murder, correct?
Ma'am, I'm only the assistant director of the NBI. The position will be taken by our director, Director Heran, ma'am.
Oh.
We stand by the director.
I'm sorry, Director Girian.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
I have already indicated earlier that we stood by with our decision.
Okay.
For murder. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Again, let me reiterate that with your Senate findings, your unbiased hearing, the Senate findings, yung NBI, yung mismong unang team ng DOJ, at yung IAS, lahat sila murder ang kanilang itinuturo dito. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Before I recognize Senator Hanasan, may I request that we yield the floor muna kay Senator Bam for a couple of questions.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Firstly, before I ask IAS Attorney Triambolo, I would like to echo what our chairman said, no? And to commend our state prosecutors. Alam ko pong hindi madali ginagawa ninyo. I can only guess that you're under a lot of pressure. Pero nandito po kayo, standing by your information and standing by what you think is right, and that is your job, no? Doing the right thing sa inyong trabaho. So, my hat's off to you kasi hindi ho madali ang ginagawa ho ninyo. Si NBI rin, no? Director Giran, alam ko po, hindi to madali. I know that you will keep your professionalism throughout these
Thank
times.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. But walang pressure po sa amin.
All right. That's walang good. Pressure. That's good to know. Sometimes po kasi ang pressure, kahit wala ho nagsasabi, nararamdaman mo pa rin eh. 'Di ba? Kahit walang nabubulong, nararamdaman mo pa rin, no? So in any case, I admire your standing your ground, no, on this matter. Let me ask Attorney Triambolo. Kanina po tinanong po kayo ni Senator Poe if you stand by your recommendation that meron pong murder na nangyari, and you said yes, no? Tatanungin ko lang po, kung sa tingin niyo po murder, bakit yung recommendation po ninyo na penalty naging suspension? Hindi ho ba kapag may finding ang IAS na murder and that's a capital offense, the recommendation administratively should be dismissal? Hindi ho ba ganun po yung pangkaraniwang recommendation?
Yes, sir. we are governed by the NAPOLCOM circular, sir.
Opo.
That those charges namin, yung grave misconduct, grave neglect of duty and serious liability, dismissal po yung kanyang penalty, no? Because that is grave. However, in the same circular, inaallow po yung there are circumstances affecting po yung liability, no, nung penalty ng dismissal, yung tinatawag nating aggravating and mitigating circumstances. So in this case, the respondent presented their awards, commendations, etc., which is under the NAPOLCOM circular po, yun ay pwedeng magamit ng mitigating circumstances, no, similar sa korte. And then dapat ang kanilang penalty ayon sa NAPOLCOM circular is the minimum period, which is the 60 days to 180 days. Pero kung merong aggravating, then sit off po yun, offset. Then kung ang penalty dyan ay nasa medium period, which is demotion in rank. So here, hindi naman talaga namin tinitingnan po yung murder. Kasi yun po ay yan po ay criminal po yon. Kasi kung merong illegal acts committed yung isang empleyado, ang tinitingnan po ng sa amin sa PNP yung kanyang asta, yung kanyang ginagawa bilang isang empleyado. Mm-hmm. Pero po yung kanyang violation ng penal code, which is murder, yun po ay jurisdiction po ng korte at paparusahan po siya ng penalty provided by the Revised Penal Code. And then, doon naman sa biktima na isa pong aggrieved party, yun namang pag-violate yung kanyang certain rights, yung pagpatay ng kanyang yung kanyang life, no? Pagpatay, pagkuha ng kanyang life din. Sa amin po yun, yun po yung tinitingnan. So dito, pinipilit po namin na makahanap ng aggravating circumstances, which is not alleged in the complaint. Pero dahil yung aming prosecution ay chinacharge siya si same with yung kanyang bilang prosecution ng criminal, although nag-grave misconduct lang general, kahit na ano po yung mga ginagawa niya, nilalamsam po yun. And then iniisa-isa niya, yun po yung ginagamit, okay, namin na bilang aggravating, because it is also provided in the NAPOLCOM circular na pag merong counts, merong other counts, no, pag dalawa yung counts, yung isa yung gagamitin mo, yung higher penalty bilang kaparusahan, then the other should be constituted as gagamitin mo bilang aggravating.
Okay.
So therefore, the conspiracy, dalawa po yung patay doon.
So two counts.
Kaya yun ang ginagamit naming aggravating circumstances. Kaya napunta po sa medium period, which is demotion in rank.
Alright. Let me ask, no, ano po yung scale ng mga penalties sa administrative? Ano po yung pinakamababa? Reprimand?
Yes, sir. Yung light offenses, yung least, simple misconduct.
Is reprimand, no?
That is reprimand to suspension to 30 days.
Okay, yung next?
Then least grave po, yun po yung 31 days to 59 days.
Okay, and next?
And then the next is from 60 days to dismissal from the service.
So 60 days to dismissal is your highest offense. So 60 days to dismissal is the highest offense.
For so grievous misconduct.
Ang sinasabi niyo ho, pasok pa naman yung 4-month suspension sa highest offense. Is that right?
Actually, sir, ganito po yung... Kung ang findings po namin, ang command responsibility under the NAPOLCOM circular po, ay simple neglect of duty lang. Kasi wala siyang ginagawa doon sa mga pag-violate, sa pagpatay ng mga inmates inside the...
Sorry, so neglect of duty lang yung kay Superintendent Marcos?
Yes, sir.
But I thought earlier you agreed with Senator Po na murder nga yung nangyari.
So far as doon yung mas IDG sa loob, sir.
Because so iba yung determination mo for the PNP inside at iba kay Superintendent Marcos.
Because as I explained earlier, yung there must be agreement. Wala po kaming nakitang direct evidence na nag-agree sila beforehand to kill the Mayor Espinosa Anyaf. So, kinukuha
excuse
lang
me,
namin
Attorney
yung conspiracy.
Triambulo. Excuse me, let me acknowledge the presence of the Majority Leader, Senator Soto, and the Minority Leader, Senator Drilon.
Hindi,
thank you, please go ahead.
It is in our report na nag-meeting po sila at 6 p.m. the day before. Nasa report po namin yun. Alam niyo ho yun?
Yes, sir.
And you didn't recognize that as agreement na nag-usap-usap, may plano, pumunta doon, pinalabas yung guard, pinatay yung CCTV, that was not agreement na so sa tingin mo the rest of the PNP did it by themselves na hindi alam ni Superintendent Marcos, yun po ba sinasabi ninyo?
Yes, sir, yung conspiracy si sir under the jurisprudence of Supreme Court kailangan i-prove po ng a crime itself, like dito yung sinabi nating murder halimbawa, so kailangan mayroong agreement to kill, so doon sa kanilang operation.
But
yung
agreement
briefing,
is not only verbal. Agreement can be exhibited through acts. Is that correct, prosecutors? That's correct, no? The lawyers behind me are saying it's correct. So, sa tingin mo, yung act of nag-meeting sila, sabay-sabay silang dumating, pinalabas yung mga gwardiya, at nandun naman si Superintendent Marcos, initially, bukas yung CCTV, pinatay yung CCTV, he was there also, that's not enough to show that kasama siya dun sa mga nangyari.
Sir, Marcos,
ang hinahanap niyo ba, MOA? Nag-MOA sila, nagagawin nila. Anong hinahanap mo?
Sir, Marcos, hindi pumapasok po doon sa loob ng jail.
Oh, but nung pinalabas yung mga gwardiya, was he also absent there? He
wala,
was there.
Wala po din, sir, doon. Nasa highway po siya, nakita lang niya na medyo mayroong sagutan doon sa pagbukas ng pinto. Doon sa pinaka-gate mismo, sir. And then, sabi niya, kasi wala namang evidence against the record kung ano yung ginagawa. He's the one giving nung kanyang role doon sa yung kanyang role doon sa pangyayari na yon.
Okay.
Na nandoon siya sa area pero he remained doon po doon sa highway.
All right. I will yield to the chairman. Si chairman was whispering that Superintendent Marcos was directing the ganun po ba yun? Yung pinaka-head pupunta lang?
He was directing the operations. Well, he was not inside the jail premises. Dahil siyempre, may papatay dun eh. Hindi naman kailangan nandun siya eh. Makaka-witness pa siya. Diyan lang siya sa labas. Pero he was directing the operation, the overall, di ba? Alam niyang pinaluhod yung mga pulis na gwardiya dun, yung augmentation. Alam niya lahat yun eh. Alam niya rin yung sinasabi ni SSP Alejo na yung nag-deponent may physical impossibility na nandun siya nakapasok sa jail kasi he was 120 kilometers away at may biometrics pa nga na nagpapatotoo na hindi siya pwedeng nasa two places at the same time. Alam lahat ni Marcos yon. So, what are you telling us now na hindi siya part ng conspiracy? Hence, ang kanyang penalty, suspension for 4 months. But before that, gusto ko i-address ito. Ang kanina pa ma'am, minemention yung ano, di ba? Yung NAPOLCOM Memorandum Circular. Ang nire-refer mo is 2016-002, hindi ba? Okay. Address ko ito sa NAPOLCOM, pati kay GPNP De La Rosa. Section 10.
prohibition on reassignment of respondent during dependency of an administrative case. In this case, for all intents and purposes, the administrative case against Marcos et al. Is still pending. Kasi naka-MR nga eh, kaya nga hindi pa natse-serve yung 4-month suspension dahil naka-MR. In other words, the administrative case is still pending, right? Okay, tutuloy ko. A respondent PNP member shall not be reassigned or transferred to another city, municipal, police station, or unit during dependency of the case unless the concerned disciplinary authority or IAS certifies that the presence of the respondent is no longer necessary. Have you certified that the presence of Marcos and company is no longer necessary?
That no. Will be
yes or no? Yes or no?
No, sir, because okay. Wala na then po yung kaso sa amin.
I will direct my question now to Chief MP De La Rosa. What is now your basis in giving Marcos and the others the reassignments or new assignments? And in that regard, no, tutuloy-tuloy ko na, tutuhugin ko na papunta kay Vice Chairman na Kasuraw. Ito aakyat to sa inyo, sa office ninyo. I just want to pick your mind.
Unfortunately, sir, the penalty is only suspension.
Hindi na aakyat sa inyo.
Hindi na, because sa our jurisdiction.
Final executory.
Yes, unless it's a demotion in rank or dismissal.
May demotion, meron demotion eh.
Opo, ayun na. Pwedeng i-appeal sa amin po.
Will you
yun.
Reverse this or will you affirm the decision of the Chief PNP?
If the environment, Your Honor, is the same as the environment when it was being investigated by the Senate, we might reverse it.
What kind of... Yung environment, hindi naman nag-change eh.
I mean, the
set of evidence, the set of witnesses, pareho eh.
Opo. But
so wala mag-change na environment unless... The environment that you're referring to, yung environment sa Malacanang.
What I mean, Your Honor, is iba po yung proceedings na nangyari sa IAS at saka iba yung proceedings na nangyari sa Senate. The perception of people during the Senate investigation is different from the frame of mind of people during the pre-charge investigation before the IAS.
Sa amin po rito, to the right of me, to the left of me, dito sa side na ito, isa yung environment eh. Murder, premeditated, grave abuse of authority. Pag sinabi natin grave abuse of authority, it carries the maximum penalty of dismissal. Diba? And the dismissal of a superintendent is within the authority of the Chief PNP, not even the President. Kasi hindi naman presidential appointee yan eh. Diba? Ikaw ang pwede mag-dismiss. So, kindly comment on Section 10 of NAPOLCOM Memorandum Circular Number 2016-002 on giving assignment or reassignment.
Sir, it says here, Your Honor, that a respondent PNP member shall not be reassigned or transferred to another city, municipal, police station, or unit during the pendency of the case unless the concerned disciplinary authority or IAS certifies that the presence of the respondent is no longer necessary. In this case, Your Honor, I being the disciplinary authority and IAS are in agreement that the presence of the respondent is no longer necessary since the hearing of the case is already finished. We have already rendered our
But they filed a motion for reconsideration.
Yes, Your Honor. But tapos na yung decision namin.
Where is the certification of IAS that their presence is no longer necessary?
Sir.
Show me. Where is the certification? Did you certify?
No, sir. But this...
No. Where is the certification? I'm asking you. And when did you issue the certification?
Hindi po kami pwedeng mag-issue, sir, dahil wala na po yung kaso sa amin. Kasi no. this provision applies only during po yung inimbestigahan, pinupsikot at hinihiring. Pero after noon...
Wait. You admitted that the administrative case is still pending. Why? Because they filed an MR. So pending pa, hindi wala pang final resolution, di ba? Okay. Pag sinabing pending pa yung kaso, covered ng Section 10.
Okay, sir.
Teka muna. unless, nakalagay dito, the concerned disciplinary authority or EAS certifies. Kaya tatanong ko, nasaan yung certification mo na hindi na kailangan yung presence nila?
May I clarify, sir?
Yeah.
Kung titingnan po yun, sir, na nandyan po yun nakasulat bago yung decision ng disciplinary authority. So, hindi po saklaw po dyan yung pendency during motion for recognition or during appeal. Yan po ay haba pong inimbestigahan at kung during hearing at kung kailangan pa rin yung respondent o hindi na kasi siya ay i-resign, so kailangan, dahil kami mo nag-hearing ng kaso, so hingian kami ngayon ng certification kung i-allow ba namin siya na i-resign kasi kami pong mahirapan mag-service ng mga notices. Pero pag tapos na po yung proceedings ng EAS at may decision na po yon, hindi na po yon saklaw po dyan sa Section 10 na po yun.
Isn't there a possibility that the GPNP will refer it back to you or the case for review dahil merong motion for reconsideration?
No, sir. The procedure sa PNP po, sir, once natapos na sa EAS at may decision, wala na po yung EAS na papel dyan kasi recommendatory lang kami, taga-imbestiga, prosecute, taga-hearing. And then, ang magre-resolve po dyan, sir, kaya hindi ko alam po yung motion dahil ipapile po yon sa nag-implement ng decision ng GPNP, which is DPRM.
DPRM? Ba't nag-imbestiga ang DPRM?
No, sir.
Execution sila, implementation.
Yes, sir, pero meron silang deload, nag-resolve ng motion for reconsideration ng decision ng GPNP. Hindi po ang EAS.
So, never nangyari na yung GPNP ni-refer back sa EAS yung kaso on the basis of a motion for reconsideration. What if new evidence is discovered?
Sir, in this case, sir, the deload or deload of DPRM, sir, the disciplinary law and order, discipline law and order division of DPRM will help me resolve the motion for reconsideration, sir.
On the basis of the records?
Yes, sir.
Lang?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Senator Nasan.
Sir, may clarify, sir, Your Honor, sir, that Superintendent Marcos et al. Were never reassigned. They were just back to their mother unit after their restoration back to full duty status. Balik sila sa ADG, Your Honor. No reassignment, Your Honor.
That's not too technical kasi pag nilipat mo from Leyte to SOC Sergeant, that's reassignment.
Yes, sir, but still sa IDG.
Yung unit, yung sa NSU, tama yon, walang reassignment because yes, bumalik lang siya sa CIDG. But then, effectively, he was reassigned from Leyte to Cotabato or SOC Sergeant area, di ba?
Geographically, Your Honor, but
same unit.
How do you call this? Mother unit, Your Honor, is still the same.
Anyway, sige. Si Senator Nasa na.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. General De La Rosa, you are at the center of all this, no? Because Superintendent Marcos is a PNP officer. Okay, let me share this with you, no? Ganito ang dating sa members ng committee. That's why these issues are being raised, no? Sa committee level, please bear with me. No? Evident premeditation plus homicide, ang conclusion, murder. Okay? Is that a fair statement? Okay. EAS, conspiracy at command responsibility. Correct? Accurate so far, no? Pumasok yung NBI. Okay? NBI. NBI ang complainant. Correct, Director Aguirre? Findings, murder. Okay? Prosecutor, findings, murder. And then DOJ, downgraded or reversal, homicide. Are these accurate statements so far? Broad strokes. Yes? Any objection to the accuracy?
In so far as the word reversal, because it's more of modified the resolution, Your Honor.
Okay, whatever. I'm talking from a layman's point of view. Now, let's fast forward. So, General De La Rosa, rini-assign back to full duty status si Superintendent Marcos dahil nag-usap kayo ng Commander-in-Chief. Sabi niya, kulang tayo sa tao. Okay? Sayang yung sweldo dyan. Yes, i-assign mo na. Anyway, hindi pa naman na-resolve sa korte.
Yes, Your Honor.
Correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, we have a manpower shortage. Now, let me go back to Prosecutor Alejo. Ma'am, you have been 23 years as?
Nag-start po ako State Prosecutor during the time of then Secretary Drilon.
Okay, good. Your mentor, you should be proud that this is here. Okay. In the legal profession, gano'ng katagal na po kayo?
Legal profession?
Yes, before prosecutor.
More or less po, almost 30 years na po, because I started with the
FBI. I'm not trying to betray your age. Ah.
It's okay po.
Okay. Oh. So mga 30 years na?
More or less po.
Okay. I'm starting with you, ma'am, no? Because you heard about this, what did you call this USEC or say? This downgrading or reversal? Modified?
Modified, Your Honor.
Downgrading?
Well,
layman's terms.
I cannot even say downgrading, Your Honor, because this is still okay. A killing that happened. It's just a matter of having a qualifying circumstance, Your Honor.
Okay, we will not split hairs on this. No? Back to Prosecutor Alejo. No? Sabi nyo kanina, nabalitaan ninyo ito sa media.
Yung pong resolution ng sa PetReb po, petition for review.
In layman's terms, in English.
Yung pong in-issue po nilang resolution ng Office of the Secretary po.
Okay. Prosecutor Alejo, walang obligasyon sina ang DOJ na sabihin sa inyo na may modified downgrading. Wala?
Technically po, wala kasi po nung designate na po yung mga prosecutors sa Leyte. Wala, we are divested of authority na po over the case.
Opo. Tiga saan ho kayo, ma'am?
Manila po.
Ah, Manila. I mean, province, Manila?
I was born in Manila po.
Ah, okay. So you learned, wala rin kayong obligasyon na alamin kung bakit may modified.
Opo.
So wala.
Wala
and
po.
You attribute this to prerogative and discretion.
Opo, tsaka po nasa rules on appeal naman po that the Secretary of Justice may modify, affirm, or reverse the resolution of the Office of the City Prosecutors, Provincial Prosecutors, Regional Prosecutors, and Office of the Prosecutor General po. Okay.
And from your narration, earlier narration, this is not the first time this has happened.
Opo.
Do you accept this as a matter of due course? Is there a systemic problem? Are there subjective elements being introduced in the process? Is there a political dimension to this? If you think you are comfortable answering this.
To my mind po, I think it is their own appreciation of the facts and application of the law and jurisprudence. Because when I saw the resolution that they issued, they also cited jurisprudence naman po. So, and to our minds too, din po, I speak in behalf of the panel, na we don't have any monopoly naman po kung tama or mali kami. So, palagay ko po the best po na ang courts po.
Okay. I hope you don't mind. I'm asking these questions. No? Now, I'm glad you spoke for the panel.
Apo.
You are speaking for the panel as Apo. The panel of prosecutors.
Apo.
You have a family?
Yes,
Good. Because I will ask you this final question. Ito ay hearing ng Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs, Primary Committee, at saka Committee on Justice and Human Rights.
Apo.
Correct, no?
I mean,
you're informed, no?
Apo.
Ako naman, ma'am, no? Prosecutor Alejo, I'm talking also from the point of view of a layman. I just happen to wear this temporary costume of a senator.
Apo.
Kaya tuwing nalalabuan ako sa sitwasyon, I fall back on... Ang hirap basahin ng buong constitution, di ba?
Apo.
I fall back on the Bill of Rights.
Apo.
Protection of life, liberty, and property.
Apo.
I ask you if you have a family.
Apo.
Ano sa inyo ang dating nitong pangyayaring ito? Di ba? In terms of enforcing public order, going against dangerous drugs, and considering the principle of balancing of interests, no? Yung epekto naman sa justice, and human rights, yung karapatang pangtao. Not for you and me, but for your family, your children, your younger brothers and sisters. If you are free to share with us your views, para we can look at it also from the perspective of the audience on national television.
Actually po, well, as a person, not really as a prosecutor, a state prosecutor yes, for yes. that matter, but since I would say that I am so religious po, I respect each and everyone's principles or opinions. But then again po, when things, when I think things are not what it should be, then I rely on my religion, and I usually say at the end of the day, bahala na po yung Diyos.
That's I'll try to see if I can adapt that, no? That principle. But I empathize with you because you know, prosecutor, that's exactly how I
Nasan was not asked of me. I would have not known how to answer it. So just for the record, Mr. Chairman, I'm torn between the death of a suspected drug lord and a possible violation of legal rules and procedures. So with that, I prepare to keep my mouth shut. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Majority Leader. Senator Drilon is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I'll ask questions from a fellow member of the bar, Undersecretary Reynante Orseo, whose controversial downgrading is the cause of this hearing today, in addition to the reinstatement of Colonel Marcos. Just a few preliminary questions. First, where is our DOJ secretary? I was not here earlier. Where is our DOJ secretary?
Your Honor, as manifested earlier, the secretary is in Bulacan attending with the
I'm sorry?
He's in Bulacan right now, Your Honor.
He's in Bulacan and engaged in what, if I may ask?
I don't have any particular details, Your Honor.
Well, I leave that to my chair, what he wants to do with the absence of the Department of Justice Secretary. But is it correct that you are from, where did you graduate? Where did you finish your law school?
From Adelaina, Your Honor, but I came from San Beda also.
You are a San Beda graduate?
I already graduated from Adelaina University, Your Honor.
But you also went to San Beda?
Yes, that's right, Your Honor.
And in San Beda, you were a member of the Lex Talionis fraternity?
Yes, Your Honor.
And you graduated when?
In Adelaina, Your Honor, in 1998, Your Honor.
Sorry?
1998.
You finished your law?
Yes, 1998, Your Honor.
And when did you pass the bar?
1999, Your Honor.
1999. So that's roughly 8 years or so since you became a lawyer.
No, Your Honor, it's about 18 years, Your Honor.
18 years. Now, were you in, what's your experience in prosecution?
And before I joined the government, Your Honor, I'm in active litigation, Your Honor.
You were in active litigation. All right. Now, when you first in the, when did you join the Department of Justice?
Since just last year, Your Honor.
Last year. All right. Together with Secretary Aguirre.
Yes, Your Honor.
Now, in the Department of Justice, during my time, there was a rule that where it involves the reversal of the finding of the prosecutor conducting the preliminary investigation, that reversal must be done by the Secretary of Justice. In other words, an undersecretary cannot reverse the finding of the National Prosecution Service. It must be the secretary himself. Is that still the rule?
No, not anymore, Your Honor.
Do you have supervision over NAPROS?
Your Honor, we have the secretary issued several department circulars authorizing the undersecretary to act on petition for review and automatic review, Your Honor.
Mm-hmm. Can I get a clarification from or a confirmation or an explanation from on the present on Alejo, Prosecutor Alejo?
Yes, sir.
On the present rule in the department?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We're still enforcing the rule on appeals, which was issued and implemented in the year 2000, Your Honor, since the time of Secretary Tuquero.
Mm-hmm.
And in that particular rule on appeal, Your Honor, the Secretary may modify, reverse, affirm the resolution of the offices of the city prosecutors, provincial prosecutors, regional prosecutors, and the resolutions of the prosecutors in the office of the prosecutor general, sir.
So the net result is, can you repeat that again? Only the, what is the role of the undersecretaries and the secretary?
The role of the undersecretaries were not mentioned in that specific rule on appeal, sir.
Mm.
But later on, during the time of Secretary Aguirre, sir, he issued circulars wherein he delegated his authority to review to the undersecretaries.
So any undersecretary can review and reverse?
The undersecretaries under him po.
Yeah, the undersecretaries.
Apo.
Any undersecretary can review and reverse.
Yes,
or
po.
Affirm the
yes,
finding
sir,
of all right
for the Secretary of Justice po.
For the Secretary.
Yes po.
Okay. Now just procedurally it was proper for Yusek Arceo to reverse. I mean procedurally it is within his authority.
Yes po.
All right. Now, let's just settle that. All right. Now Mr. Undersecretary Arceo, I am told that you did not consider the evidence presented during the investigation in the Senate for purposes of reversing the finding of the prosecuting fiscals here.
Yes, Your Honor, that's correct, Your Honor.
You did not consider it all.
Yes, because Your Honor, that's not part of the record of the case, Your Honor.
Yes, these are public records, and but you okay? Whatever is your reason, the fact is, you just disregarded the findings of the Senate Committee and the Senate itself.
No, Your Honor, maybe clarified. I didn't disregard it. I'm just saying that resolve the matter based on the record, Your Honor.
No. All
if
right.
if that investigation forms part of the record, I will definitely consider it.
Now, we provided the Secretary of Justice with a copy of the Senate resolution, if I recall correctly. So, remember, this is not just a committee report. This is a resolution adopted by the entire Senate. And this was provided officially to the Department of Justice. But notwithstanding this, you simply ignored and disregarded the findings of the Senate because in your view, this is not part of the record. And yes or no?
Yes, Your Honor, with that qualifying okay. Words of that part of the record, yes, Your Honor.
Yes, all right. So, baliwala sa iyo ang Senado, baliwala sa iyo ang findings ng Senado. Now, going to the findings of the prosecutors. The prosecutors recommended murder. Is that correct?
That's correct, Your Honor.
The NBI recommended murder.
Yeah, that's correct, Your Honor.
Your secretary himself, in the hearings here in the Department of Justice, said the killing was murder.
I'm not aware of that, Your Honor.
Oh, you are not aware of this. And you think we believe that you are not aware of this, Prosecutor Arceo?
Your Honor, to be candid, Your Honor, I did not listen. I did not read the report yet. And I am not watching the Senate investigation.
Now, on the record, okay, you said you did not know. Now, I will tell you, and I will read from the transcript. Okay, question on your Secretary of Justice. When you conduct a raid in the Munting Lupa, kayo po ba ay nag-a-apply or mag-a-apply ng search warrant? Answer of your secretary, we did not apply for any search warrant last July 20 when the SAF took over. Is there a need for a search warrant? I'm sorry. He said, so there is, I said, there is established that a search warrant was applied for before the raid in the provincial jail. Is that usual? He said, very unusual. Is that, and then he said, and then he said, so unusual, Your Honors, as a matter of fact, instead of calling for SOCO, kung talagang gusto nila, they went to enforce the search, implement the search warrant. They have called for the barangay officials in the area. But what is most important is that your Secretary of Justice said this is a premeditated killing and therefore a murder. Now, if you read this opinion of your Secretary of Justice, would you render the same ruling that you did?
I think, Your Honor, you're referring to the November 20, 2016 Senate hearing.
Yes.
And I cannot guess on what the Secretary is thinking like at the time when he testified, but I could only surmise that it was done when the investigation is not yet fully done, Your Honor.
Yes, but the facts were already established at that time, that the search warrant was served at 4:30 in the morning, that the SOCO was called at 3:38 in the morning, as if anticipating that something will happen, and a number of other facts which indeed showed that this was premeditated. The fact that a search warrant was issued when, according to your secretary, this is most unusual because Mr. Yap and Mr. Espinosa were under the control of the penitentiary, of the detention system, and they knew of the alleged firearm 1 week before the raid, and yet, under all of the circumstances, which was within which which your secretary came to know, he said it should be premeditated murder. So you disregarded this opinion of your Secretary of Justice?
Your Honor, and just like my previous statement a while ago, the Secretary is not does not have any hand in the drafting of this resolution. I personally made it, and what I'm saying, Your Honor, the Secretary does not intervene.
Sorry?
The Secretary does not intervene in what we do.
No, I am not saying that he intervened. What I'm saying is you disregarded this an opinion of your Secretary of Justice?
Your Honor, as I said, I have my own opinion based on the record. Uh-huh. If that statement is not form part of the record, I would...
Was it part of the record that the raid was conducted at 4:30 in the morning?
Yes, that's right, Your Honor.
Huh?
That's correct, Your Honor.
That's correct. Was it part of your record that the search warrant was applied 1 week before the raid was conducted?
I believe, Your Honor, it's just a day before, Your Honor.
Yeah.
The search warrants, November, I still recall, Your Honor, it's November 4th, when the search warrant was applied.
No, I'm sorry. They came to know of the existence of the firearm 1 week before the raid, or the application for the search warrant.
Yes, Your Honor, based on the intel report,
yes.
Affidavit of the police
that's
officer
on record.
Who applied for the search warrant, Your Honor.
Now, it's also on the record that for a guy who was detained and for the search warrant to be served in a detention place, 13 policemen conducted the raid. That's also on record.
Yes, Your Honor. It's actually, Your Honor, a total of 19.
Sorry?
19.
Correct.
Include the regional maritime unit, Your Honor.
That's correct, yes. Total of 19 implemented the search warrant at 4:30 in the morning after they called the SOCO at 3:30 in the morning. Is that correct? That's on the record?
Yes, Your Honor.
And notwithstanding all of this, you believe it was only homicide?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. And you're saying...
Yeah. Very brief question, yes. Senator Dilan. Before it escapes my mind, you mentioned that you approved and signed the resolution downgrading murder to homicide without the knowledge of the Secretary of Justice.
Yes, Your Honor, because
he didn't know that you signed, that you approved and signed the resolution.
Yes, Your Honor, because under the department circular, we are authorized to sign in,
yes,
in his behalf, Your Honor.
The same department circular says that you are authorized to approve, sign or approve resolution, decisions for and in behalf of the Secretary of Justice.
Yes, Your Honor.
Ano bang understanding natin ng for and in behalf?
We are signing in behalf of the Secretary.
So it should be with his knowledge. You cannot sign something for and in behalf of any person without his knowledge.
Yes, Your Honor. Technically, that's correct, Your Honor.
So are you still maintaining that the Secretary did not know that you signed and approved the resolution?
No, Your Honor, this is what happened, Your Honor. When I made the resolution and I signed it, I didn't even inform the Secretary that I made the resolution. We just mailed the copy of it. So under the presumption that we are doing it in his behalf.
So presumption lang yung for and in behalf of the Secretary?
There's a presumption that he knows that what we are doing, Your Honor.
Anyway, thank you, Senator Drilon. Nahirapan ako magtanong kay Yusek Arceo kanina pa.
Ako rin nahihirapan maniwala eh.
Okay. Now, Mr. Arceo. Homicide is included, I mean, murder includes homicide, the same elements between murder and homicide, except that in homicide, in murder, there is qualifying circumstance. Is that correct?
Yes, yeah, that's correct, Your Honor.
Abuse of superior strength, what else? Conspiracy.
Premeditation, Your Honor.
Oh, all right. In this particular case, you believe that none of these elements were present, notwithstanding the fact that they were on record?
Yes, Your Honor.
You did not believe that there were circumstances which showed conspiracy?
No, Your Honor. In fact, that's why all of them were indicted for homicide, because there's a conspiracy.
Okay. The use of superior strength.
I did not consider that, Your Honor.
You
because
did not
I believe being a police officer and they're supposed to implement a search warrant, they had to be armed, Your Honor.
There were 19 of them who implemented the search warrant. That is not abuse of, that is, when, and they entered the premises.
I think we have to refer that matter to the operational guidance of the PNP because they be the one who will determine what will be the necessary force that would be needed in implementing such warrant, as in this case, Your Honor.
Mr. Arceo, as a matter of procedure, the court could have convicted those charged with homicide even if murder was charged, correct or not?
Honor,
huh?
That's possible, Your Honor.
No, that's procedurally that can be done.
Your Honor, yes, procedurally, that's allowed by the rules, but
that's
then there's a lot of mechanism that are in place that it may not happen, Your Honor.
That may or may not happen, but that is the discretion of the court when they receive the evidence.
Yes, that's right, Your Honor.
If indeed you believe, given the publicity given to this and the circumstances that were present, wasn't the better part of discretion to leave it to the court if what offense or crime was committed, if indeed the evidence would only show homicide, not murder, they could have been convicted of homicide?
Your Honor, I believe it's the duty of the
No,
DOJ.
Answer me first. Answer me. Could the court have convicted them of homicide?
Yes, that's possible, Your Honor.
That's possible. Now, so that on the basis of the same evidence, the court now could convict them of homicide.
Yes, that's possible, Your Honor.
Now, you do not, but you found it urgent, necessary, and I do not know for what other reason, you found it necessary for you to exercise that judgment
and downgrade the case to homicide without waiting for the court.
Because that's the duty of the investigate of the DOJ.
That's right. But also, with your downgrading of the case, they could no longer be convicted of murder.
That's right, Your Honor.
Do you think that's that will serve the ends of justice?
I think we have our rules promulgated by the Supreme Court. Whatever happens to that rules, it is for the Supreme Court to act on it.
I see. So, as you said, Mr. Chairman, I find difficulty understanding this in the same manner that you have difficulty understanding the overall picture. Anyway,
another interjection, yeah, yes. Senator Dillon, for the for SSP Alejo. Yung date ng resolution niyo, March 2, hindi ba?
Yes, sir. Apo, that's
when did you transmit the copy of resolution to of your resolution to the respondents? Anong date? Kung meron kayo dyan.
Around March 6 na po.
March 6. So, na-receive nila yung copy ng resolution March 6.
Apo, most probably po.
And the petition for review was filed on April 5. Yusek Arceo, na i-file yung petition for review ng respondent Marcos et al. April 5. They received the copy of the resolution on March 6, according to the prosecutor. Hindi ba nag-lapse na yung period kasi 15 days lang yung period within which they can file a petition for review. And therefore, kung nag-lapse na yung 15 days, hindi na valid yung petition for review. You could have dismissed outright.
Your Honor,
teka muna.
Yes.
Pakisagot nyo lang. Di ba 15 days?
Your Honor, we
as
have
per your circular.
If we talk about the days you on,
that's upon correct. Receipt.
But then we have a procedure in the DOJ.
Teka muna. Liwanagin mo natin. Di ba upon receipt ng copy ng resolution ng respondent, doon ang reckoning date ng mag-file ng petition for review. And you received the petition for review on April 5. So between March 6 and April 5, 30 days yun, di ba?
Your Honor, we still have to wrap it. It's not actually filed right before the office.
The date of
the
filing,
the DOJ, Your Honor.
The date of the filing should be within 15 days upon receipt of the copy of the resolution.
Yes, Your Honor.
And according to the prosecutor, may kopya sila dito na natanggap yung copy ng resolution March 6.
Your Honor, March 6 was that date of the mailing. It was mailed to the respondents.
So, meron kayong record as to what date?
Yes, and then we filed it on the same date, Your Honor.
Ne, pero may record kayo kung anong pecha natanggap ni na Marcos yung resolution ninyo?
Not individually, Your Honor, kasi po baka iba-iba yung dates ng pagkaka-receive po nila.
Anyway, I'm just trying to, I'm trying to assail the resolution. That's my really the reason for asking these questions, including yung inclusive period na authorized kayo mag-conduct ng petition for review. As you said, theoretically, I'm correct when I said na illegal yung ginawa niyong resolution at hindi valid because labas na doon sa July 1, 2016 hanggang December 31, 2016, di ba? Inamin nyo rin kanina yon.
Hey, that theoretically, I have no authority to sign. I still stand out with my conviction that I am authorized under the circular.
Well, let's stick to facts. Let's stick to the facts. Department order or department circular number 19. Ulitin ko. No, kasi wala si Senator Drilon, wala kaming katulong na abogado rito sa aming panel. Ngayon, we have a copy of circular number 19. Ang nakalagay doon, although dinedelegate ng Secretary of Justice named the undersecretaries concerned who can conduct the petition for review or approve and sign. No? Ang nakalagay doon, all petitions for review na na-file within the period July 1, 2016 until December 31, 2016, yun lamang ang pwede nilang i-resolve, i-review. But the review was conducted, actually the resolution was issued on May 19. But it could not be possible na
nag-conduct sila ng petition for review from within July 1 hanggang December 31 because ang resolution ng panel, March 2 of 2017. So ang tanong ko, Senator Drilon, would that render illegal or invalid the resolution issued by Undersecretary Orseo on the basis of their own department circular?
Mr. Chairman, under the department circular 003 of the DOJ.
003, right. But it was qualified it by a subsequent circular number 19, which incidentally, sabi ko kanina, nawawala sa website nila. Kaya lang, nakakuha kami ng kopya at na-qualified doon na pwede lamang i-review yung petitions filed within that period.
Yeah, can I answer that question in a few minutes? Allow me to read the circulars. In the meantime, I suspend my interpretation on USEC or say. Or other colleagues may want to ask questions.
While waiting, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Majority Leader.
Not directly connected, but with the DOJ. Are you familiar with the circular issued by Secretary Datumanong before on drug cases? All dismissed drug cases must be submitted for automatic review to the Office of the President.
Yes, yes.
You familiar
yes,
with that?
Yes, sir.
And then during the last administration, during the time of Secretary De Lima, they removed that. It's no longer circular, that same circular. They said automatic review to the Office of the SOJ.
Yes, Your Honor.
What is it now? I told Secretary Aguirre that
Your
that
Honor,
should be
this
again.
Still automatic review to the Office of the Secretary, Your Honor.
It's the same circular?
Yes, Your Honor. No, we have a new circular, but exactly the same content, Your Honor.
Why don't you put it back to the Office of the President? That second circular, if you're still doing it now, that is very controversial. Diyan yung napakaraming drug cases na dismissed. Nung napunta sa DOJ yung ang mga review, dumami ang dismissal. You should bring it back to the Office of the President. Well, that is a suggestion. I hope Secretary Aguirre will
discuss the matter with the Secretary.
It has worked for the previous administration, during the time of Secretary Datumanong and the rest. No, so I hope you will bring it back there. Thank you.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, from the way I understand this, the prevailing rule before Department Circular Number 3 was that only the Secretary of Justice can reverse this, and sign resolutions on review of the prosecutors. That was the prevailing rule, existing circular signed by then Secretary Toquero. Now, there was a Department Circular 003, which authorized certain undersecretaries to conduct petitions for, or to rule on petitions for review, but only for a limited period. Until 31 December 2016. So obviously, after the lapse of this period, it goes back to the original circular of Toquero, which the Department of Department Secretary should now be the one to act on petitions for review. Now, Mr. Orseo acted beyond this period, and he could only do so with the authority of Secretary Aguirre. And Undersecretary Arceo, we lawyers know that when we appreciate evidence being presented, including testimonies here, it must be consistent with our ordinary human experience. That's the first rule of credibility of evidence. You should know that. And it is not credible that you tell us that you did on your own the downgrading of the murder offense, number one, given the fact that your secretary expressed a different opinion, given the publicity given and the public opinion generated or condemnation, public opinion generated by this case. You are saying that malakas ang loob mo, hindi mo ba nang tinanong ang inyong kalihim kung pwede ba natin i-downgrade ito. So, notwithstanding all your statements, you are not credible because what you are stating is contrary to human experience and the way we conduct things in the bureaucracy. Wala naman po maniniwala na i-reverse nyo ang opinion ng Senado, ng NBI, ng DOJ panel, at ng sekretaryo mo mismo at sinasabi mo, hindi ko siya kinonsulta, akin lang po ito. At ang sinasabi maliwanag na ang kapangyarihan mo ay nag-lapse na under your department order. So, all of this makes your statement that you did this on your own absolutely incredible. And especially considering that you could have left the discretion to the court because they could have been convicted of homicide anyway, even if they were charged with murder. Now that they are charged with murder, they cannot be convicted of homicide. Now they are charged with homicide, they cannot be convicted of murder. In any case, Mr. Chairman, I think we, you know, it's useless to keep on asking questions from you, Secretary, or you keep on covering up.
Are you, Yusek? So, nagkakaintindihan na lang tayo sa ngitian. Anyway, to the members of the committee, we have a majority caucus at 1 o'clock. So, I think we should suspend first and hold another hearing. Maybe in the next hearing, well, we can ask more questions kasi medyo kulang tayo sa oras.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Senator Nasan, please.
Mr. Chairman, one last brief point I want to direct to General Del Rosa. You know, General Del Rosa, we are generating a lot of flack. Well, I'm not worried about, although we should address that issue also, no? From the global community, no? Pinag-usapan namin kami ni Chairman Lacson, yung agreement to kill, that will be resolved by legal procedure, no? That is, pero yung license to kill, yun ang magiging problema natin, no? Because the impression that is generated is that this culture of impunity that we can take human life. Wag na muna natin sabihin yung drug lord, di ba? Wait, Senator Soto, we're also weighing that, no? But that's a different issue altogether. I hope that with an improvement in our public information system, itong pinaliwanag kanina na conflict, no? In the procedure, baka you might want to address that. No. Second, maybe you can start moving towards speaking with one voice para maiwasan yung conflicting statements that generate these reactions. No? But I want to emphasize that. Yung agreement, yung conspiracy, ibang usapin yan, legal procedure. Pero yung itong impression na there are some groups or individuals that are licensed, allowed to kill with impunity, we will have to address that. I know you will not tolerate that, no? Okay. But just for the record, no? I want to lay that at your doorstep. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Last point na lang sa Napolcom, kasi yung kayo yung sa policy, di ba? How do you view all this? Ano? Itong mga recent developments about Marcos, the Marcos case, the killing of Espinosa and Raul Yap. from the point of view of policy?
That's the problem now that we are really faced with, Mr. Chairman, because this happens because of the so many disciplinary bodies that are dipping their hands into a lot of cases. For instance, the Marcos case, Napolcom had also its own investigation there. And parallel to the one conducted by EAS. So when we are asked about our perception about the case, we are constrained to express our views because there is already the rule of exclusivity that comes in. It would be wrong for us to say something on a case that is already being investigated by a fellow pre-charge investigator, so we are prevented from saying our piece on this matter because it will only...
And you did not pursue anymore your investigation because EAS had acquired jurisdiction already?
In
Marcos case?
Yes, for our records purposes, Mr. Chair, we have our own set of investigation facts that we gathered.
Do you have an initial finding?
It was actually similar
to... It's only a choice between kung grave abuse of authority, kung serious offense or less serious or light offense. Sa initial, sa conduct ng investigation, initial findings, saan papasok yung kina Marcos?
It would be a grave offense, Mr. Chair, because it's...
Which carries a penalty, administrative penalty of dismissal.
Yes, Your Honor, but... As explained earlier by the IG, Inspector General, applying the qualifying circumstance and mitigating circumstance, the grave offense of dismissal was just translated into demurrage.
Yung mitigating circumstances ng EAS, yung mga medals eh. So kung grave offense na dapat i-dismiss just because may mga medalya, ma-downgrade siya sa... Suspension lang dahil maraming medalya?
Yun po. In fact, itong mga medals at saka length of service, minsan it operates to be aggravating eh. So, it's a perception issue
mukhang,
actually.
Mukhang hindi ko ma-appreciate yun. Maraming medalya, nagnakaw, nag-extort, hindi mo ma-dismiss kasi maraming medalya.
Yun na nga.
Kung nilakad niya lang yung medalya niya. DPRM, di ba? Marami rin ganun. Naglalakad na medalya. Magaling magsulat. Hindi naman siya kasama sa operasyon. Sinasama yung pangalan niya. Di ba? Tapos dahil maraming medalya, magaling kasi maglakad, nag-extort ng pera, hindi na dismiss, binigyan lang ng suspension or demotion. Why would it be a mitigating circumstance? Dapat pagka grave offense ng penalty dismissal na, okay lang yun siguro doon sa mga medium or light offenses, pwedeng gamitin yung medalya dahil, pero pagka dismissal na, grave abuse, I don't think yung medals will count or should count. Di ba?
In law, Mr. Chair, we have the so-called alternating circumstance. For instance, length of service. This can be appreciated both ways. Kung ang length of service will help you exculpate you from a grave penalty, it will be applied as such. But if it will describe you even more, it can even merit...
Tanda mo ng servisyo, nagnanakaw ka pa.
Yes, that's right, Mr. Chair.
Hindi ginagawa mo.
Yun ang nangyayari, kaya lang...
So how would you interpret that? Discretionary ba yan on the part of the investigating... team or unit?
Yes, because this is supposed to be invoked by the party who intends to benefit from it. If it's not invoked, then it cannot be considered. So for instance, length of service, if the respondent does not invoke that, I have been in the service for quite some time, can you not consider this? Yes, for humanitarian reasons. So it has to be invoked and it has to be explained and justified by the party invoking it so that it can be appreciated in his favor.
So it is left to the appreciation of the investigating officer.
That's why it's called alternating circumstance. It can go both ways, depending on how you defend and justify it.
itong rule na ito is discussed in stone. Hindi ba pwedeng baguhin ito na pagka-dismissal, grave abuse of authority, serious misconduct, wala na mga mitigating.
Dapat, it should be considered indivisible penalty. Ang problema, pumapasok yung mga qualifying circumstance.
You want to say something, attorney?
Siguro, sir, in fact, we are bringing this to the attention of the NAPULCOM already. Since the crafting of their circular governing the disposition of administrative cases. Kasi dyan sa 6975, sir, as amended by 8551, meron po yung dalawang penalty provided sa batas. Yung, I think, Section 42, yung tinatawag natin ng para sa citizen's complaint and internal discipline. Doon po yon may range ng penalty, yung admonition to dismissal from the service. So what is internal or citizen's complaint? But meron ding summary dismissal proceedings na indivisible yung penalty. Yung, I think, Section 43, na pag ikaw ay recidivist, repeatedly charged, conduct unbecoming, serious offense, continuing conduct unbecoming, serious offense, when the evidence of guilt is strong, then yung continuous 30 days absent, isa lang po yung penalty sinasabi doon sa batas, which is dismissal from the service. Medyo kasing mali dito sa NAPULCOM circular because ang sinabi ng batas sa 6975, ang gagawan lang ng scale of penalty, which is medium, minimum, medium, and maximum, yun po lang yun po yung mga enumerated doon sa citizen's complaint and internal discipline. Pag pumasok ka dito sa summary dismissible offense, isa lang po yung penalty, wala kang discretion. You will not apply the mitigating and aggravating circumstances.
May parameters, hindi ba?
Well, yes, pero
yung
kaso
discretion
lang,
mo is just so much. You know? You can exercise it, but it's limited. Kasi sa hierarchy ng offenses versus the hierarchy of penalties, defined naman yan eh. Hindi mo pwedeng i-downgrade yung, say, serious offense to less serious offense. Wala sa discretion mo na yon. So again, balik na naman tayo kina Marcos.
Kaso sir, memorandum circular kasi implementing this law. So dapat, yung circular, yung scale of penalty from medium, yung i-divide mo by 3 period na applicable yung aggravating, doon lang po yung sa Section 42, I think, ng citizen's complaint at saka yung internal discipline. Pero pag dito sa serious offenses, katulad dito, grave offenses, dapat isa lang penalty noon, dismissal. Hindi mo i-appreciate. Pero nandiyan nga yung NAPULCOM circular, which we followed.
So, acknowledge ko muna yung presence ni, inabot tayo ni Senator Gordon. Kaya, hindi tayo pwedeng madali lang dito. Anyway, kalimutan ko tuloy sabihin ko. Anyway, you recognize, kapatid, ikaw na magtanong.
Thank you. My apologies, Mr. Chairman, and on the board of the Justice Committee, I understand this is a joint hearing. We're ready here. I just want to be clarified. When you conducted the NAPULCOM hearings, there was a funereal silence. Wala nakabalita na nag-i-hearing kayo. Tama ba yan? Wala kami nabalita. Nabulagan na lang kami. May lumabas na decision na kayo. Sunod-sunod na. Sinundan na kayo ng Department of Justice na binaba na nila yung kanilang charges from murder to homicide, and they were using your investigation as reason for that. But what surprises me and chagrins me, quite frankly, is that there was a funereal silence. This is a case of tremendous import to our country. A lot of the senators support the campaign against drugs. We support the president, we support the PNP. But when this happened, it took a wrong course from our point of view, from the investigation. How come nag-hearing kayo na walang nakakaalam? Kayo-kayo na lang.
Pero when I assume the office of the Inspector General on December 1. Tapos na po yung investigation ng Internal Affairs Service ng Region 8 noong November 21 under the motu proprio power ng IAS na pag mayroong sa operation may namatay o na-injured, so automatic po yun, nagkakandak
ng investigation. I understand that, sir. Pero bago nangyari yan, hindi pa rin kayo nagsabi na nag-i-investigate na kayo. Gustong-gusto ng tao malaman kung ano ang disposition ng kaso. Di ba? I mean, everybody wants to know, ano bang ginawa nyo doon sa kaso? Ano nyo, nagtataka ako eh. Ito mga taong pinatay nyo, eh, guilty na sa buong mundo yun eh, dahil talagang involved eh. Alam nyo, nakasama na sa kaso, na involved sa drugs. Pero napakasalahula naman ng trabaho na yan. Eh, nasalahula na ngayon trabaho nila, Marcos. Sasalahula pa sa investigasyon nyo. Sino yung nag-imbestiga doon sa hearing, sa summer hearing na sinasabi niya? You have to have a summons, di ba? 3 days?
Yes, sir.
Oh, hindi namin nabalitaan yan. May nakabalita ba sa mga kasama natin dito? Pagkali ko, wala. Pagkatapos yan, meron kayong 7 days to answer. Nagbigay ba ng answer?
Yes, sir.
Kailan ka pumasok nung nagbigay na sila ng answer?
Yes, sir.
Oh, so sa Bacatuid, ikaw na talaga nag-conduct.
The investigation was completed noong November 21. And then, nung binirify ko po yung kaso, nung later part ng, on the basis of the evidence gathered on the investigation no, na complete ng November 21, yun po yung pinagbabasihan ng charges na inapprove po yung acting...
When you say na kompleto na November 21
po, sir.
Anong proseso ang ginawa doon?
Anong proseso
ang sinunod nyo?
Napulcom circular, sir.
Pareho tayo abogado, nagbabasa rin ako. Inuulit ko na nga, ang proseso nyo, 3 days summons, tama?
That is during ano na sir yung pag na-file na po yung charges po.
Kaya nga, may preliminary investigation kayo, di ba?
May pre-charge investigation
yung
po.
Yung pre-summary hearing, di ba?
To answer lang sir then pre-hearing conference.
Oh, may pre-hearing conference kayo.
Yes sir.
Hindi pa ikaw 'yon.
Ako na po sir.
Oh, so saan ka pumasok bago pre-hearing conference? Ano ang papasok bago nag pre-hearing conference?
Filing
answer, na... yung answer.
Yes, sir.
Nandun ka na rin?
Yes, sir.
Anong papasok bago yung 7 days answer?
Doon po dyan sa after filing ng formal charge, sir.
Oh, nag-file kayo ng formal charge. Sabi yes, mo, sir. November 21.
On the basis ng investigation
correct.
Ng IAS 8.
Oh, ng IAS. Yun nga, di ba? Ano ba kayo? Sorry, ano ba kayo? Kayo ba yung appeal squad kayo? Nasa Napolcom ba kayo?
Hindi po, sir. Sa IAS.
IAS pa rin kayo? Oh. Paano nangyari? Anong IAS? Sinong IAS? Dalawa bang IAS?
Isa lang po, sir.
Oh, sino yung IAS na nag-imbestiga ng una?
Yung Region 8 namin, sir.
Region 8, nag-imbestiga sila doon?
Yes, sir.
So may finding na sila doon?
Yes, sir.
Anong finding nila?
Eh, yung findings, sir, yung ang investigation ng Region 8 is more on fact findings. So they are gathering investigation.
And I understand then, that. Anong resulta ng investigation?
Gano'n sir, mayroong yung killing.
Murder? Homicide?
We are not charging, administrative kasi yung amin sir, grievous misconduct lang. Ang source noon, yung murder, yung pagpatay.
Okay. Ano sabi nila? Did they follow protocols? Police regulations?
Hindi po sir, kaya kasama yun din sa charges yun.
Ang sabi nila, hindi sinunod?
Yes sir.
Hindi sinunod. Okay. So pumasok ka na no, may answer na?
Yes sir.
Ano sagot nila? May affidavit sila?
Yes, sir.
Nag-hearing ka ba? Tinanong ba sila isa-isa?
Wala pong hearing yun. Under Napolcom circular.
Tinatanong ko lang dahil nanonood ang tao, hindi nilalam yung procedures niya. Alam natin ang procedures na summary, practically. So, yung answer ninyo, may sulat sila doon. Meron silang affidavit, di ba?
Yes, sir.
O, ano sinabi nila sa affidavit nila?
So, usually, sir, denial.
Denial. Ano dinideny nila?
Yung there was no agreement, like Marcos, wala siya doon sa lugar, nandoon siya sa highway, etc. at mayroon siyang instruction na to observe human rights, etc. And follow the police officer procedure. Yun po yung mga sinasabi no sa kanyang affidavit.
Kay Marcos yun?
Yep, sir.
Okay, sa iba?
Ay, sa iba naman, sir, yung kanila Laraga and Duarte, Matira.
Oh.
So, sabi nila, lumaban. Yun po yun. But hindi po
lumaban?
Namin. Yes, sir.
Hindi na kayo nagtanong yung bago na lumaban?
Yung bago lumaban, sir, meron kaming mga nakakuhang witnesses na yung nakita nga naming mayroong conspiracy kasi doon sa kanilang synchronized action.
So, may conspiracy, sabi mo?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sinabi mo may conspiracy. Lumabas ba sa report may conspiracy?
Yes, sir.
That kasi kung may conspiracy, that means may premeditated.
Hindi na namin focus yung murder, sir. Basta yung concerted action toward the same objective to kill the Mayor Espinosa and Yap. Yun lang po pinagbabasihan because we are not charging them on murder.
There was a concerted effort to kill Espinosa.
Yes, sir. There
that was your finding,
yes,
that
sir.
This group went in there and there was a concerted effort to kill Espinosa.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And you're just saying na yung concerted effort, gagawin nyo lang homicide, hindi murder?
Hindi po sa
when you
amin
say concerted
yun,
effort to kill, when they go there to kill, that's premeditation. When they kill, that's murder.
Yes, sir. But yung amin lang kasing tinitingnan, sir, yung criminal aspect kasi, sir, yung NBI ang nag-imbestiga niyan. Sa amin, administrative, which is grave misconduct. Yun po yung...
Ano lang sa inyo?
Yung sa amin po, sir, administrative lang po, yun.
Alam ko, administrative yun. Pero you made a statement here. You made a statement here that they were there with intent to kill.
Yes, sir.
Oh,
based
so,
on
okay.
Their concerted action inside
concerted
the jail.
Concerted action to go there and kill these people. You weren't looking at murder. You're just... Nonetheless, the same acts, even if you don't call it murder or homicide, they're part, from your view, your legal mind, na administrative lang hinahanap niya. Tama? So sa administrative, titingnan nyo lang, may misconduct ba sa paggawa ng inong order?
Yes, sir.
Anong yes, sir?
May
misconduct?
May misconduct, sir, because they killed the inmates while in the process of serving search warrant inside the jail.
Alright, yung bang warrant, naniniwala ka na kailangan pa yung warrant sa loob ng jail?
Hindi, on the administrative aspect the case, sir, di po namin yung
tinitingnan. Yun ang ilag mo na naman, administrative yes. Case. Huwag na pag-usapan, pareho tayo abogado. Kailangan ba yung warrant sa jail?
In my opinion, sir, as a lawyer, hindi kailangan.
Hindi kailangan, thank you. So, pagdating mo doon sa loob ng kulungan, tanongin kita, tumawag si Matira ng alas 3:45 sa Soko. Nakuha niya ba yan?
Yes, sir.
Base yan ba yan sa administrative case?
Yes, sir.
Base yan, okay. Pero namatay, nagkabarila na, nakapasok sila 4:30. Doon sa pinto ng jail, dinestrong kayo ng susi, di ba?
Matikting doon po sa mga affidavits admitted by the witnesses, the respondent.
I'm just using Mr. Marcos's claim that they had to break the key para makapasok. Dahil binali ng gwardiya yung susi, yung kandado doon sa gate, para di sila makapasok. So, tarihin kita. Paano nila nabuksan?
Based on the record, sir, sinira nila po yung...
Paano nila sinira?
Yung bolt cutter nila, sir.
May dala silang bolt cutter.
Yes, sir. Yun po yung sa mga witnesses.
Ang ibig mo sabihin sa akin, magdadala ka ng bolt cutter para i-investigate mo yung jail, magdadala ka ng bolt cutter? May baong kang bolt cutter?
No, sir.
Oh, so, may baho sila. Ang tawag doon, pinaghandaan. Do you agree with me?
Pinaghandaan po yung pag...
Mga Boy Scouts sila, laging handa. Papasok
yes,
tayo dyan. Ayun tayo, warrant. Diyos oras ng gabi, ha? Di ba?
Yes, sir.
Tapos, meron silang handang bolt cutter. Pagpasok nila ngayon, may mga pulis doon, di ba? Nagbabantay. Bukod doon sa gwardiya, may pulis pa nagbabantay kay Albuera.
Yes, sir. Na doon po yung mga affidavit ng mga gwardiya, sir, na pulis nakadetail doon.
Yung ba kasama sa protocol, papaluhurin nyo yung pulis na yan?
Ay, hindi kasama, sir. Kaya nga sinacharge din namin sila on that aspect.
So, pinaluhod, pinatalikod. Kasama ba sa administrative proceedings yan?
Yes, sir. Kasama sila.
Mali ang ginawa.
Mali, sir.
Iskandak. Right?
Yes, sir.
At habang ginagawa nila, may telepono or may radyo or whatever it is kay Marcos na nasa labas. Konektado.
Wala po yun doon sa record, sir.
No, nasa record namin dito eh. Tumatawag si Marcos sa kanila eh.
Yes, sir. Because the investigation was completed while you are conducting investigation.
Correct. So, ibig sabihin, anong completed na investigation? Ninyo?
21 pa, sir. Complete na po. Nung pinorward na po ng IAS.
We don't have a copy of that results of those investigations. In fact, I kept harassing IAS. I used the word harass because to the point I was so frustrated with IAS, I was already calling IAS IWAS. And I'm not glad standing here. I am very pro-police. I was a mayor. Pagtaba ang ginawa ng police, like Mayor Duterte, I will back them up to the hilt. I will even provide a lawyer. I was a lawyer, a mayor for 13 years. Sabi ko pa sa mga pulis tong araw, bawal mamatay. Dahil uso ang Sparo. Don't make the NPA look good at the expense of the policeman because ang pinapatay ng Sparo, di umano yung mga masasamang pulis. So my record is very clear and I just want to tell you that I am pro-police because I am pro-law and order. And I am pro-police for so long as they follow the rules. So when they brought the bolt cutter, they went in there, pinalabas sila, under the, meron pang warrant kunyari-kunyarihan, they were already maladministering the law. They're already in maladministration. I will just use that term. So, nung pinaluhod, wala. You punish them for that, right? Tapos pinalabas sila lahat yung mga pulis. Tama?
Yes, sir.
Pinalabas sila yung mga gwardiya. Tama?
Yes, sir.
Is that part of the rules of procedure?
That's why we charge them for violations of the police officer procedure.
And what,
sir,
do you call that? Grave misconduct.
Yes, sir.
What do you call that? Malfeasance.
Irregularity in the performance of duty, sir. That is
they, what do you call that?
Yes, sir.
The irregularity. Malfeasance. Because a murder or a killing resulted. Malfeasance. In Latin, mal. Masama. Ang paggawa ninyo ng feasance ninyo. Performance. Tama?
Yes, sir.
Misfeasance.
Sa criminal po yun, sir. Malfeasance and misfeasance.
Wala, hindi criminal, administrative yun.
The NAPULCOM circular define what are the administrative offenses, sir. To so, categorize to grave
I'm
misconduct.
Not here. I do not enjoy what I'm doing. To truth to tell, these people are guilty of stupidity, if not crash. You know, the stupidity. Pag pinahili ang kasong yan, tayo-tayo na lang nag-uusap sa buong mundo. Alam ng buong mundo, si Albuera kasama sa droga. Tama? Yung anak niya, number one drug pusher doon. Sa palagay niyo, kung pinahili niyo, General Bato, General De La Rosa, yung kaso dyan sa mga yan, may magtitistigo kaya? Nakakahiyang magtistigo dyan. At the very least, matatakot sa mga pulisya, magtitistigo. Alam naman ng tao na mga matay tao kayo, kayo yung mga drug pusher. Kaya, stupido ang tao ko dyan. I'm sorry. Mabigat na salita rito. Dahil, it's really stupid for them to go in there, palabasin mo yung lahat, sirain mo yung kandado, may warrant-warrant ka pa. Pagkatapos, pagdating doon, papalabasin mo. Nung pinalabas, is that kosher in administrative proceedings?
Sir, that's why we found him guilty as charged.
Guilty pa rin.
Nine yung pinahil namin.
Nine
guilty
charges. And yeah, what did you do? A clap in the wrist? Ibababa nyo lang yung sentensya ng one? Kung sasaban nyo yung sinasabing merong mga mitigating circumstances na magaling ang servisyo ng araw?
That is what provided in the NAPULCOM circular, sir.
Let me ask you a simple question. Were you in the military?
Yes, sir.
Were you ever in the military?
No.
You're a lawyer?
Yes, sir.
All right. Let us say, just an example, Guerra. Ang galing-galing, si Odie Murphy. The most bemedaled soldier in the United States Army in World War II. Halimbawa siya, ang galing-galing niya, daming action, lumalabas siya. 1 second, he deserted. What will he be guilty of?
Disloyalty, sir.
Desertion.
Yes, sir.
Desertion is punishable by what? Firing squad, correct?
Yes, sir.
So hindi ko ikakaut yung mitigation pag kami pumatay ng tao. That is our in aid of legislation here. Pwede namin pasukan yan. But this is unforgivable. How can you sit down there and say that? You know, it's so hard to go through this. It's agony for us. Because we're on the side of removing drugs. Salot talaga yan eh. You did them a favor. And yet, what do you do? Anong sentence ang binigay mo?
Guilty as charged ng grave offense. So, ang range ng penalty kasi provided by the National Service is 60 days to dismissal from the service. So, if there is aggravating and mitigating circumstances, this will affect the...
Aggravating and mitigating are criminal terms.
Yes, sir, but this is provided in the Napol Commissioner.
So, what is convenient in that Napol, in that code, you will use. When it is inconvenient, you will not use. Kasabihin nyo, hindi administrative cases lang ito eh. Hindi pwedeng criminal case ito. Pero sa criminal law, aggravating and mitigating, those are criminal law terms to either make the penalty higher or to lessen the penalty, correct? And yan ginagamit nyo sa Napol Commune, parang convenient. Ang tawag ko doon, parang sinulat yung batas na magkabaro tayo, gibigyan natin ng pagkakataon lahat, kahit nakabaro natin yan, pag sinira ang pulis, sira lahat eh. Sakit ng kalingkingan, sakit ng buong katawan. Kahit na magaling yung pulis, pagka siya nagkamali, at iba ng klase ang ginagawa niya, dapat paparusahan. Pero anong sentensya nyo sa kabuuan?
That's why...
One degree lower.
Yes, sir.
Ang rank. Ano, one rank lower. Di ba? Demotion?
Demotion.
Demotion.
Because we are using the other charges as... Which the respondent found culpable as an aggravating circumstances to offset nung mga sinasubmit nila ng mga mitigating circumstances. That's why we are advocating, sir, that to revise the Napol Comm Circular because sa 6975 kasi, sir, I explaining before, meron kasi po yung scale ng penalty doon sa internal discipline and citizens' complaint. Pero meron ding provision na wala pong discretion, you should not apply. For me, as a lawyer, yung interpretation ko, yung sinarawang summary dismissal cases, which ang disciplinary authority, DINAPOLCOM, the regional director ng PNP, and the chief PNP, doon po isa pong penalty lang ang provided by law. When the violation is serious and the evidence of guilt na dito eh napapaon nga natin na mayroong conspiracy, dapat dismissal po yon. But however, mayroon pong Napol Comm Circular implementing this law na ginagawang pariho yung skill ng penalty.
As a lawyer, sir.
Yes, sir.
Don't you think you want to make a recommendation na baguhin yan para talagang mabangon natin ang karangalan ng pulis?
Matagal na po.
Ang galing-galing, ha? Tingnan nyo ang ratings ng presidente. Taas. Taas. Pati pulis gumanda. Pati military, agganda ngayon. Isang mistake na ganyan, masasaktan ang buong kapulisan. Mga kasama ko dito, General Lacson, si Gringo Nasan, stake his life to change the previous regime. Pero, itong nangyari dito, hindi naman ako galit kay Marcos, hindi ako galit. Alam mo, nagagalit talaga kami dahil talagang masisira yung ginagawa eh. So I want to ask the Secretary of Justice now. Who is representing the Secretary of Justice here? Yusek? Yusek? Yeah, I know your name. I'm sorry, I read a little.
Reynante Orsay, the honor.
Yes. With all due respect, don't you think that these people were guilty, premeditation yung sinasabi. Sabi nyo, hindi, walang premeditation. Ikaw ba ang gumawa na itong, ikaw ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Did you not see premeditation?
Yes, Your Honor, I didn't find any evidence of premeditation in this case, Your Honor.
There is no premeditation whatsoever?
Yes, Your Honor.
Why?
Mr. Your Honor, if we go into the requisites of evidence of premeditation, it would not apply in this case, Your Honor.
How can it not apply? They come by night. They come with abuse of superiority. 19 policemen come at night. They have a warrant of arrest which is spurious, which every lawyer says you don't need a warrant. You're in the Department of Justice. You mean to tell me the Department of Justice should get a warrant, a search warrant to go into the jail? Is it not true that under jail conditions, anybody in authority with prior permission from the jailer or anybody among there or a policeman, if you have information, you can go right there and say, Mr. Jailer or whatever, I want to investigate. Gusto ko lang tingnan, may baril raw dyan. Do you need a warrant for that?
Your Honor, first to answer on the evidence premeditation.
Please answer my question first. Do you need a warrant for that?
Your Honor, it's actually a judgment call.
No, it's not.
I think it is, Your Honor, because you have to consider the authority, the command structure of the BJMP, if they will allow you to go there inside. Did they try? If you have a class.
Are you aware that there were two other killings involving the same modus operandi? Pumasok doon sa jail, pinatay yung tao, kunyari may warrant?
I'm not aware of that, Your Honor.
Well, you better be. You're in the Department of Justice. There were two cases that Senator Lacson and I found prior to this where policemen went inside the jail, showed the search warrant, and killed the people inside. Are you countenancing that? Pinapabayaan mo yun?
I'm definitely not, Your Honor.
Well, I'm glad to hear that. I suppose you're from San Beda.
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, I'm sure they have a very good law department there, Redes Aguizag, Dean Ledesma. A lot of people went to San Beda that I deeply respect. I don't think even your deans or your teachers will side with you that there is no evidence. When you bring a bolt cutter, I would ask you the same question.
Your Honor, it's for the PNP to decide. Because under the rules, Your Honor, it can actually force open any buildings and establishment if you are refused entry, Your Honor. That's allowed under the rules of court, Your Honor.
That
is allowed, Your Honor, to force open yourself if you want to implement something.
But this is a government office that you're going into.
Yes, I believe, Your Honor. That's why, Your Honor, I also believe in that. But then, again, it's a matter of operating procedure.
It's a very hard thing that you're doing, having to defend something that is indefensible. And I'm not going to admire you for it. A little candor would be nice, because you're representing your school as well and your integrity as a lawyer. I hope you realize that.
Yes, Your Honor.
And I'd like to be your friend.
Me too, Your Honor.
Good. So having said that, when you bring a bolt cutter, when you bring a spurious warrant, and you cut that, and there's a claim by Marcos na yung gwardiya mismo binali yung susi sa kandado, eh, ba't di natin hinuli yung gwardiya? Pinailan ba ninyo yung gwardiya? For obstruction?
I think it's for the NBA to do that, Your Honor, because we have an interview. You know, that's under the level of the investigation. There should be a complaint to be filed.
Did you recommend that at least?
No, you cannot even assume that on that first level. We cannot investigate. We cannot even file. We could only review and decide on what is on the record, Your Honor.
I don't know. I don't know what they taught you in whatever it is. No, I call it mediocrity. And I know General Bato and General Lacson here, they know they would be what you call innovativeness. They would call it a way upon which you can get things done and improve the situation by coming out with suggestions and say, this is highly irregular, therefore we should file a case. These rules in the POLCOM are not in point, and you would change it. Otherwise, the next thing, it will happen, and we will lose the respect of our people.
Just to inform you of what we are doing, at least in my office, we are doing that whenever I see.
You're following the Hitler argument.
No, Your Honor.
Nuremberg. I was just ordered. I didn't know anything about it. I didn't know that there was an oven there killing people. I just kept quiet. And I just did my duty. I'm a magistrate of the law. I'm not supposed to find out. Kung hinaharang yun, kung palagay mo, hinaharang talaga yun at nagkagulo doon, hindi na umabot sa law, buhay pa siguro yung mga tao doon. That is precisely why the Senate investigates. Senatus populusque Romani, Senate and the people of Rome, to prevent a dictatorship or a dictator named Caesar, merong Senatus. Dito, kami ang Senatus ngayon, and we're not drunk with power. We just want to make sure that when we make laws, they're followed, and that our policemen live up to the standards that they're expected of them, and therefore, gusto namin maayos ang ating implementation. Kung mali yung tao natin, huwag natin pagtakpan. You are not my friend. You are my subordinate. I have said that many times. I have classmates working for me, and when they follow up, I tell them, I'm sorry, buddy. You're working for the government now. You are not my friend. You are my subordinate. And if you do not follow the rules, give me the recommendation to improve it. But this is clearly a case where we're looking the other way. Nanunood ang buong Pilipinas sa atin dito, mahirap ang pangdagon. I don't envy you. I don't know why Secretary Aguirre is putting you up to this. In the first place, it is up to him to affirm, modify, review. That is what the rules of the Secretary of Justice before said. But if you keep changing it, it's what you call moving the goalposts. You change the rules in the middle of game to suit your current objective, which is not the way the law is found. It must be predictable, it must be consistent, it must be continuous. That is good law. When you change the law when it is convenient for you, that is no longer good law. You know that the Department of Justice is being pilloried for this. We have investigated two of your colleagues here, say immigration, and there was a case. A lot of people, I was under pressure to go after Secretary Aguirre, and I did not because there was not enough evidence against him. I was convinced. I was pilloried in the social media. Sama dapat si Secretary Aguirre. Hindi ko ginawa. Hindi ko kilala yan. Hindi ko kaibigan yan. But I follow the law. You must follow the law. Eh, ano ngayon? Again, I'll ask you the same thing that I asked them. Pag pinali yung kaso dyan, alam lang nyo ang record yung mga yan. At alam nyo galit ang tao dyan sa mga yan. Alam nyo, pabor ang tao sa pulis sa mga hinuhuli nila mga drugs at kumisan nagkakamatayan pa. Do you think may magtitestigo yan pag pinali nyo yung kaso? That's speculative. That's hypothetical. And most probably, pag dilatan lang ni Bato yung magtitestigo dyan, titiklop na yun eh. Sorry ha, General Bato ha. Pandilatan lang ni Marcos yun, titiklop na yan. Bakit yun, itataya pa yung mali? Hayaan nyo husgado na mag-desisyon. Eh, ang NBI sinabi, di ba? Sinabi ng NBI, murder. Sila ang first impression, di ba? They were the ones who investigated it. And your Secretary of Justice said, double murder. Ba't nagbago? Sometimes the president is want to say things that he doesn't really mean. Paputok lang yan eh. Mayor rin ako, ginagawa ko rin yan eh. Ginagawa rin, I'm sure ni General Bato yan. Pag hindi nyo ginawa, bubugbugin ko kayo. Patihin ko kayo dyan. Pero hindi niya kasi sabi yan, hindi niya. He doesn't mean that. Pero kayo, sambutin nyo na. Sabi nyo eh, as PC Director General, PNP Director General, boss, magalit ka na sa akin. Guilty. Murder. File natin, sir. Oh, pagdating sa husgado, baka nakalusot pa yan dahil hindi dumating yung testigo. Hindi pa nabawasan ang testimony, ang statement ko, why do you waste, Mr. President, your political capital on a case where the people clearly see that these people committed a crime? Hindi naman na makakalusot sa tao yan kahit na makalusot sa inyo yan. They are guilty already. Ang pinag-uusapan ng mga tao sa Jansan, sabi, naku, delikado kami dyan. Is that what we want? So, on that matter, I know that I wish I could have another, but I apologize to the chair. I will withdraw already. I think the points have been made. I don't even want to ask General Bato anymore because...
Ako, I have one final just to wind up para sa PNP. Yung regional director ng CIDG sa 12 TO position ba yan for senior soup?
Entry position, Your Honor.
For senior superintendent.
For senior soup, Your
Honor. So, in all likelihood, after 6 months, senior superintendent Marcos.
If he's not disqualified, Your Honor, then
he's qualified.
He can be qualified.
So kaya nga, we're looking at senior superintendent Marcos 6 months from now. Because yun ang parang residency requirement, di ba? Sa isang
yes,
position.
Yes, Your Honor.
So,
Your Honor, unfortunately, there is a law that allows promotion even if there is a pending case.
You know that. Kaya nga, kasi nga nasa position eh. And I suspect now that the reason why he was given that position is for him to get promoted.
In fairness to the law, this was crafted to insulate policemen from harassment cases.
And this is a harassment case?
No, I mean the general intention of that law. Nataon lang dito
I,
kasi.
I only said that in general.
yes, Your Honor.
Just a couple of things for the record. I will refer this to the Undersecretary of Justice. Same modus operandi. A certain Francisco Balagbis. Same jail. Bye-bye. BJMP. Killed October 28, 2016.
Same group.
General? Same group. Number two. Edgar Allen Alvarez. Leyte Regional Penitentiary. Abuyog, Leyte. Same province. You know, even the judges shame themselves for allowing this group to have a search warrant to go to a jail that you don't need a warrant to. And then, DOJ Department Circular, I was in the helicopter kahina coming from Laguna because we put up a building in Laguna. I was asking my staff to brief me on the phone. Section 12, disposition of the appeal. The secretary may reverse, affirm, or modify the appealed resolution. He may motu proprio or upon motion dismiss the petition for review. I just want this for the record. I don't think I need to do this, but para lang makatulong. And I would advise all of you, I would advise Director General na baguhin niya yung PNP rules na may mitigating circumstance pagka nakamatay na ng tao. Iba na yun. Baguhin rin yan. So, Your Honor, with all due apologies to you, I'm like this all the time. When I was a lawyer, I was like this. I don't enjoy it, but kailangan maganda ng takbo natin kahit pa paano. Magagalit pa sa akin. Pero sinasabi, we're countenancing that. That's why I just want you to know, on third reading yesterday, na-pass na yung batas na dito, I hope the House will follow, na yung mga motorsiklo ngayon, malalaki na yung plate number. Natutulungan na yung mga paglabo na mata. Makikita nila yung plate number. Yung CCTV, pinagkagastusan natin, makikita na yung plate number. Pinakamarami. Just for the record, 2,000 deaths. Halos wala tayo nasa-solve. Makakatulong sa pulisyan. Those are the things that I'd like to hear from you guys so we can help. And we'd like to help. We want you to succeed. Thank you, Mr. Tarambulo.
Yeah, and the chair would like to thank the resource persons. So this hearing is suspended until further notice. Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Seguimos.